All right, hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. I hope my voice is coming good and clear. Please inform me if you have any difficulty from your side. Before we start today, I would like to invite everybody to share in a nice conversation, no bad words, no bad language. Muslims, Christians, Jews, Hindus, atheists, whoever you are, just please speak with respect and let us be nice. The purpose of our video today, as usual, is education, and education is good. Never hurt. The more you know, the better you are. But we have a special enemy, the enemy of Allah. Always when I read Islamic books, I ask myself simple questions. Who is talking there? And what kind of a person this person is? The Muslim, they claim that the Prophet of Islam, he never gave an order from his own. Actually, they support that from the Quran, where Muhammad, he says that Allah says that whatever Muhammad he say, it is not from him, it is from Allah. And Allah, in case you do not know, he is the God of the Muhammadan. And the Muhammadan believe that this is the only God, but who cares if he is the only God or the second God or the third God? This God is weird. In chapter 53, verse number 4, it says, it is no less than inspiration sent to him. Him who? Muhammad. So what the inspiration sent to Muhammad? The inspiration sent to Muhammad that dogs are the enemy of Allah. They are najis. They are filthy. They are dirty. And even he ordered in the beginning to kill all the dogs, with no exception. And then when people, they start complaining because they need dogs. I mean, a human being depend on dogs in many things, especially we are talking about the old days. Maybe today, most of us, we live in civil cities. We do not need really dogs. But in the old days, people, they grow cattle, they have sheep, they have a goat, they have animals and goats. And like, I mean, all those animals, they need protection and they need even a hardened dog. So when Muhammad, he ordered to kill the dogs, that was based on what? Remember, the Quran said, as we showed you in the chapter 53, verse number 4, that anything Muhammad he say, it is from Allah, which means his orders is holy orders. He is God on earth. He don't speak from his own. It's God talking. So today we are going to talk about a bunch of or list of animals Allah he have a phobia with. He considered them their his enemy, but those enemies, they don't make sense. As you see in the front of us, the Messenger of Allah command that all dogs to be killed, except dogs used for hunting or herding livestock. But this is not really the beginning. The beginning, he ordered to kill all the dogs. Let's go down. All those hadith report for us that there is something fishy and something wrong. Allah said to Muhammad that he who kept a dog other than the one meant for watching the herd or hunting would lose every day 2 kirat of his good deeds. Kirat is a kind of a scale to measure things. And imagine Islam is using what is things you measure weight with it, or measuring some physical things to measure your deeds. And just because you have a dog, Allah will take from your deeds. So every day Allah will take what is equal to 2 kirat. I don't know what is that, 2 kilos. The Messenger of Allah ordered killing the dogs, as you see all over. And the dogs over, obviously, they have a problem with Allah. The Messenger of Allah order to kill all of the dogs and then said, why the people after them dogs? Then he granted permission to keep for hunting. So in the beginning, he ordered to kill all dogs with no exception. And then he noticed that this is not right. I mean, people, they are complaining. But Muhammad, he go farther in his phobia. As you see in this hadith, the Messenger of Allah said, and this is Sahih Hadith from Sahih Muslim, so Muslim cannot say to us, this is a fabrication, blah, 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 you know. The Messenger of Allah said, when one of you stands for a prayer, there is a thing before him equal to the back of a saddle that cover him in the case there is not before him a thing equal to the back of a saddle, his prayer would be cut off by the following: passing off an ass, which means a donkey, a woman, and a black dog. And here we see the phobia of Muhammad extended not only to animals, even to women. So your prayer is not accepted by Allah if there is a donkey he walk by. I mean, think about it. You are praying to Allah and a donkey walk by. So Allah will not accept your prayer. Let us make the thing is more visual. This is a website I use for, because it's a free copy, righted pictures. So let us see here what Allah is talking about. What is this animal? Maybe some of you do not know what is donkey. Let me introduce for you Mr. Donkey. This donkey, if he walk by, Allah don't accept your prayer. I mean, look at him. It makes sense. I mean, how God can accept my prayer if this donkey is walking by? And look, he's looking at me. Actually, he's looking at you too. Actually, something very, very, very fishy about this donkey. So there is no way Allah, he made an order, such an order or teaching, unless it makes sense. And it makes sense. And look, he's even moving their tail. And not only that, he is turning his back to the ocean and looking at us like, you know what? Like, do you see what I can do? So Allah, if you pray and a donkey walk by, Allah will say, no, 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 take your prayer back, is not accepted because there's a donkey was there. I mean, isn't it obvious that this is makes sense? And if you notice with me, I don't know how many of you are smart like me, because I'm an Arab and you are not, I feel sorry for you, but we are the smartest. If you notice with me here, you will see that this donkey, one of his ears is here and the other ear is not, they are like, you know, he's playing with them. He's not only walking by, he's making fun of us. And I think this is the reason behind Allah not accepting our prayer. It's very amazing. It's a very deep wisdom. It's a very clear message from God that this donkey is going to cause a problem. But why not the horse? What about the mule? I mean, the mule is half donkey, half horse. Is he? No, only donkey. Horse is not. Mr. Donkey, you have a problem with Allah. Here we notice the intelligence of this religion and the intelligence of the founder of Islam. There's no question that this is a very, very smart decision, and now we knew what is wrong. Now, what else? If we go back to the hadith, it says that three things interrupt the Muslim prayer. Not only a donkey, as we showed you, a woman. Now I understand that this is really very dangerous. Let us go and get a picture of a woman. So, because many of you do not know how women look like. Okay, I found a woman. No, this is not a woman. Okay, what about this one? No, this is not a woman too. These days it's hard to know who's a woman, who's not. Okay, I found a woman. All right. So let us say you are praying to Allah. And then this woman, she walked by. Allah will not accept your prayer. I mean, she's a woman. Hello? Look like the reception of Allah, or let us say the Wi-Fi of Allah, can be interrupted so easy by a woman walking by. And actually, I agree. Each time a woman walk by my house, I lose connection with the internet. So obviously, you will lose connection with God. Isn't it obvious? I mean, we have to be smart here. So a woman walking by and you are praying to Allah, Allah will not accept your prayer, because here we go, the woman she walked by. The phobia of women. So we saw first the phobia of a donkey. Now we saw the phobia of a woman, and then what? What else? Is the phobia is going to stop here? No. And the black dog. Here you notice that Allah, He put the women between two animals. One is an ass, and the other one is a black dog. Take selfie. I mean, I don't know if any women of you, she have a donkey at her farm, and she have a black dog. If you please, you can, if you like to share your picture with us, send us a selfie, because we want to see how this is look like. A donkey and a woman and a black dog. Those interrupt the Muslim prayer. Let us go and search for a black dog. All right, black dog, black dog. What are you gonna do? Okay, what is the black dog? I need to say, find the black dog now. Black dog. It's not easy to find the black dog, especially in Islamic world. They will kill them because Muhammad, he ordered to kill them. Okay, black dog. Here we go. I mean, look at this guy. He is wearing a t-shirt. No, I want to choose this one. The enemy of Allah. That's dangerous. That's, I mean, look, not only he is a black dog, which is Muhammad said he is Shaitan. Look what he is wearing. This guy, he think like he is Robin Hood. Or maybe he think like he is the lady, whatever. I mean, a black dog will disturb our prayer. And look at this. I mean, it's obvious. And look what he is wearing. And look how he is staring at us saying, yes, I do it. I'm truly, truly convinced that Muhammad is speaking for God. There's no way he's not speaking for God. How he knew that this dog can disturb the prayer and Allah will not receive your prayer? How he knew that? It's obvious. It's so clear. It's like light. I just saw a vision now. The vision. I'm praying to Allah. And then a donkey walked by. Oh, this is a cow. Sorry. You know, these days we forgot how the animals sound like because we don't see them anymore. The only time we see them is in pictures. how the donkey do the voice? Like, okay, how? No, this is a dog. Like, come on, what's happening with me? I need inspiration of Allah. I need guidance. Allah, can you lead me how the dog, how the donkey? I mean, how the donkey sound like? Like, this is not a, this is a frog. This is not even, what is that? This is not a frog. This is a bird. Hello. So, I mean, just whatever it is. Don't ask me to make the sound of a donkey, please. I hear them all day long in the Sharia TV. The guy who says to you, you have to beat your wife because she is disobeying you. Obviously, he must be a donkey. But he looked like a human. Because beating women will not make you a human, will make you really something else. We go back to the topic. So until now, we saw three phobia. One of them is about a donkey, the other one about women, and the third one is about a black dog. Now, what's the problem with this black dog? It's a big problem. Very, very big problem, brother. Huge problem. The wisdom of the Prophet. One of them, the Muslims, he decided to think, so he asked a question. Why the black dog? I mean, what the problem? What the problem? So they asked the Prophet, why a black dog specifically? As you see here with us, after they spoke about this hadith, they say, I said, O Abu Dharr. Abu Dharr is the one who is reporting the hadith, the speech of Muhammad. What feature is there in a black dog which distinguish it from red dog and yellow dog? Like, why the Prophet did not say a red dog will disturb you? Well, before the Prophet he answered, I will explain to you the difference between a black dog and a red dog. Red dog? I never saw a red dog. Really red? Look at this guy. I mean, look at this guy. I mean, you cannot blame the prophet. Hello. I mean, like, come on. And he's wearing a jacket too. I mean, this is hilarious. Okay, now we found a red dog. So a red dog will not disturb your prayer, only the black dog. Like, okay, well, I don't know. I mean, both of them, they have teeth, and both of them, when they speak, they say ho ho ho, and both of them, they can bite, and both of them, they have tails. The only difference is the color between this dog and that dog. Okay, so why the color make a difference? Do we have any ustad from Indonesia? Can you help us, please? Why the red dog is okay, but the black dog is bad? Hello? Don't tell me that there is no way the prophet is anti-racism. He is not racist. He don't judge you by your color. No way. Even the Muslim, they quote for us a story. He said that the black and white people are equal, which is a false story. Any Muslim can tell us why the red dog is not a problem, but the black dog is a problem? Somebody is saying, call Zakir. My friend, I cannot call Zakir Naik, because Zakir Naik, he will not answer me unless I put a white dog. What do you mean call Zakir Naik? Secondly, you think Zakir Naik, he have time for this? He is busy collecting coins. Any Muslim here, any ustad, any scholar can tell us what is the point, why a blonde dog, redhead dog, is okay and he is not a problem for Muhammad, but call Zakir.
I told you, I'm not going to answer you unless first you tell me and you tell me your faith.
Zakir Naik, what does have to do with my face? I'm asking you a question. I need the answer. Forget about me. Answer the people who they are listening.
First of all those people listen to you. They are fake names. You are leading the digital media.
I'm using what?
The digital media.
I did not get this one.
The digital media.
Oh, you mean the digital media? Okay. So I'm using the digital media. So you are saying that all those people who they are listening to me live, they are fake?
Absolutely. And I can prove it.
Okay, go ahead. How you can prove it?
Okay, I want one of you, those people who they are listening to you, to call you and they throw themselves in the camera.
Zakir Naik, what this have to do with my topic now? Why the prophet, he don't like a black dog, but he like red dogs? What the problem? Why a black dog disturb your prayer, and why he is really anti-black dogs?
First of all, you will not understand unless you see a black dog. Have you ever seen a black dog?
Yeah, I saw a black dog before. Yeah, he was nice.
He is nice to you because you are a kafir, because you are an infidel. But the black dog is not nice for us.
Okay, why he is not nice? I mean, he's a dog. Zakir Naik, until now you failed to give me an answer.
I'm going to answer you. Open your camera and show me your faith. And then I will answer you.
Okay, you make it very hard now. I mean, okay, I can open my camera. Okay, Zakir, I will open my camera for you.
Okay, I'm going to oath.
My camera now is open. Do you see me?
A'udhu billah, you have a black dog next to you. I cannot look at you. First, get rid of the black dog, so then I can look at your camera.
But the black dog is next to me. What I can do? You said to me, show me your face, you will answer me.
I said to you, show me your face. Don't show me your dog. You are crazy. Don't call me again.
Unbelievable. Any comment? I mean, why the black dog is really scary, and why the red dog is yummy? Look at this guy. He's looking at us, says like, why me? Like, why me? Why the prophet, he hated me, what I did? I'm just little tiny one. I mean, this guy is so little tiny. And look at this jacket. Look at this jacket he's wearing. I don't know if you can see the picture. Look at me. A prophet who fear a tiny little dog, and his God is a saint just because of his color. But, you know, as I said, the prophet is all wise, all knowing like Allah. So he knew better. So when they ask him, I said, oh, Abu Dhar, what is feature is in the there in the black dog which distinguishes it from the red dog and the yellow dog? He said, O son of my brother, I ask the messenger of Allah, silence, because now the prophet of Allah will answer. As you are asking me, and he said, the black dog is a devil. Bingo. I mean, isn't it obvious? The black dog is the devil. Why he is devil? Because he's a black, according to the prophet. Who is a Muslim here can really justify such a stupid teaching? Who is a Muslim? Hold on, let me open my Skype. Okay, I'm loading my Skype now. Who is a Muslim would like to call us and tell me what is it? Is it really true that the black dog is a devil? Or this is one of the madness of someone who claimed to be a prophet? Do you really, Muslim, believe that the black dog is a devil? Is that your religion? Is that what God taught Muhammad? What do you say? Anyone? You see, you want us to believe that Muhammad is a prophet, but a prophet of God, he should say something wise, something not crazy, and he should not be superstition. This is stupid. This is not, this can't be from God. What, the black dog is the devil? It's just a dog. And just because he's a black, now we make him devil. So we make a little tiny animal satanic just because of its color. Yellow dog is fine, red dog is fine, white dog is fine, but a black dog is evil. In which religion is that? Islam. And remember, the Muslim, they say that everything Muhammad he say or he do is from Allah. وَمَا هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Everything he do is inspiration from Allah. This is why the Muslims, they have to obey. Somebody asking a question, which I find it really something smart. Look like maybe we can trick Allah. What about one of you saying, can I change the color of my dog? So if we color the hair of this dog, is he going to stay shaitan or he is going to be a good dog now? Any Muslim can tell us what this phobia, what is behind this phobia? Black color, racism, black dog, black a human, is all the same. I mean, color is just an appearance. It's the same. Black human, white human is the same. They are equal. They have the same, everything the same. It's just appearance. Black dog, white dog is the same. It's just an appearance. So what kind of a wise God, he says such a thing? You see, remember, we are talking about somebody claiming that he speak for God, not for his own. And everything Muhammad he speak of supposedly is coming from God. So Muslim cannot say, oh, this is a prophet here, maybe is wrong. They cannot say that. Phobia. What else? I'm trying to look in the text in the here we have a friend here. He's saying this comment: there are thousands of Islamic ustad in Indonesia that claim to be scholars, master in Arabic, Quran, and Hadith, but no one dare to call CP. Either they are liars or they are just scared. I don't know, my friend. I have no idea. I don't think they are scared, but they are busy. They are busy teaching very important stuff. As an example, sister, today I'm going to teach you how to shake hand with someone. He is haram. Sister, you put a tissue between him and you, and you put it in the top of your hand and you shake hand with him. This is what they are busy with. This is very important. I mean, come on. How we going to show how a woman, she will shake hand with them with a Muslim man without tissues, without this knowledge? It's very important. Let us see something else. The list of phobia is long. Let me introduce to you another list of phobia. Oh boy. We have to be honest here. This guy is like 3 centimeters tall, maybe 5 centimeters tall, but yet he scares a religion. Imagine there is a God who he teaching his followers that it's a duty to do jihad against a lizard. Lizard. Lizard is an enemy of Allah. And not only that, if you kill a lizard, look at this guy. I mean, obviously, he's an enemy of Allah. Isn't it obvious? I mean, we have to admit. Are we going to watch a movie soon? It's called Allah versus Lizard. It's just a little tiny thing, not even 5 centimeters. And Allah is considered this one an enemy for him. Let us see what the Prophet he said about Mr. Lizard. We have to call him Lister because he entered history. I mean, God himself and Lizard, they are having a problem. The Messenger of Allah, SAWS, forbid to eat the flesh of a lizard. Okay, why? Later we will show you that he think lizard, they used to be human, and Allah make them lizard. But let it go for now. It was narrated from Ummu Sharik that the Prophet told her to kill house lizard. Okay. Lizard. 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 All right. But look what happened. Here, this is science. You see, the atheists, they believe in evolution. Muhammad, he believed in it before all of them, but he believed in it in a different way. We were in army with the Messenger of Allah. We got some lizard. I roasted one lizard and brought it to the Messenger of Allah and placed it before him. He took a stick and he counted its fingers. Hold on, I need to do that by myself. I cannot just let that happen. I need to zoom in this picture here now. If there's a way we can zoom more. We need more clear picture of the lizard finger. Fingers. Okay, this guy, he have fingers here. You see, this is the good thing about education here. Now we are talking about lizard fingers. Okay, hold on. I got one. This one is so clear. Unbelievable. Okay. So guys, look what the Prophet, and look how smart the Prophet is. The Prophet is not like us. He's different. So the guy, he roasted a lizard for him, and he bought the lizard in front of him. The Prophet, he got a stick. Look how clean he is. I mean, look at it. He did not even touch it. And he start poking each one of them. He counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bingo! The Prophet, he found that lizard have 5 fingers. And now the Prophet brain start running in the speed of beyond imagination, thinking, okay, Oh, I have five fingers. The lizard have five fingers. Both of us now we have five fingers. It's obvious that lizard, they used to be human. I mean, isn't it obvious? Genius. This is not a phobia. This is genius thinking. We go back to the hadith. Oh boy. I mean, from all things in the world, I did not study except this. I mean, why I did not study to be a dentist or maybe to be to do haircut at least. I mean, no headache. I mean, look at this. Look what I spent my life studying. Okay. He counted the finger, its fingers, and then he said, a group from the children of Israel was transformed into an animal of the land. And I do not know which animal it was. Okay. And I was wondering what is intelligence is. Like when they say somebody is a genius, what does that mean? I did not really understand what the word genius mean until I did read the prophet comments and the prophet observation of things around us. Very deep. That's very deep. Extremely deep. Who can deny that this person, whoever his name is, he's a genius. And by the way, the Muslim, they might say to you, this is weak hadith, which means they try to say it is not accepted. By the way, weak hadith is accepted. It is sahih. Sahih. But the story did not over here yet. Are we done? No. We go to different hadith. We will find how much Muhammad is messed up. In different hadith, Muhammad, he said the following. All right, trying to find the hadith. Look at this. Another observation of the prophet, which no human being can come with except somebody like the prophet. The prophet of Allah said, a group of Israelites were lost. Nobody knows what they did, but I do not know, see them. Except that they were cursed and changed into rats. Like what? Rats? Hello? In the previous hadith, Muhammad is thinking that the Jews, the same Jews, they became lizard. In this hadith, Muhammad, he changed his mind. They are rats. I mean, I don't know how many sound I need to make you understand. This is super intelligence. And look how the prophet, he decided that those Jews, they became rats. Look at the intelligence here. Look at the how to analyze. Look. I mean, you guys are really, really behind. I feel sorry for you. Kuffar, you are kuffar. You are not smart. Kuffar. Allah curse you. And now the prophet, he give us the reasoning. Look, he doesn't just say things without, no, he have to give the reasoning. Very scientific. For if, this if is killing me. If I was handsome, I will find the women to marry me. If I was rich, what we can say. So for if you put the milk of a she camel in the front of a rat, it will not drink it. Look at this. The prophet, he was watching rats drinking milk of a camel. Did they drink milk of camel or didn't they drink milk of a camel? They don't drink milk of the camel. So Muhammad, he took a note. He's like Einstein, genius. The difference, not much between him and Einstein. So if you put the milk of a she camel in the front of a rat, it will not drink it. But if you met a put the milk of a sheep in the front of it will drink it. And guys, guess what? The Jews are forbidden to drink a she camel milk. And because of this, the prophet, he compare between the rats refusing to drink the she camel milk and the Jews refusing to drink the she camel milk. Obviously, those used to be Jews. Genius. Actually, one of you, he said, I thought this is the only me. I say that. One of you, he says, this is deep. Like, well, you guys are taking my words. That's deep. See, Peter, he said, this is deep. This is very deep. What are you talking about, Peter? Peter, come on, Peter. This is very deep. Deeper than the ocean and deeper than some noses. The phobia of the Jews made Muhammad see them as animals wherever he go. He saw a lizard, he think it's a Jew. He saw a rat, he think it's a Jew. Phobia. What else? Are we done? No. And by the way, what is behind this lizard? Any Muslim want to help us? And not only Muhammad, he wanted the Muslim to kill the lizard, but he said, if you kill him from the first shot, Allah will give you an extreme reward. Let us see why. We have to understand what is behind the story of killing the lizard. Geigo. A woman entered upon Aisha, and in her hand was an iron footed stick. Aisha, she have an iron stick. This is a special weapon to kill lizard. She said, what is this? She, Aisha, the wife of the prophet, said, it is for those geigo, because the prophet of Allah told us that there was nothing that did not try to extinguish the fire of Ihram except this animal. What Ihram? This was translation. The fire which is to burn Abraham. Supposedly, a bunch of people, they tried to burn Abraham. And according to Muhammad's story, all animals, I don't know if you watch cartoon. What is the name of the cartoon? Like do like animals, they do things, talk, and anyone remember one like those? I mean, there's many movies, right? So all the animals, they start coming from everywhere, insect animals everywhere, bringing water to stop the fire on Abraham, so Abraham will not be burned, except one animal, geigo. And now I'm going to explain to you why this animal. Why the prophet is right. I mean, he's always right. What are you talking about? Okay, look at this. Which one I'm going to show you? I'm not sure which one. Look at this guy. This guy, he was blowing wind at Abraham to burn him. And by the way, this is proven to be scientifically accurate. And not only that, the story says that he was able to blow wind and make the fire, like the fire, you can feel the heat from 1,000 meters away. How evil. All animals in the desert, in the jungles, in Brazil. You know, I told you I was in Brazil, right? Last time I was visiting Zimbabwe, I stopped by Brazil because it's next door, you know. And then, like, I said to myself, why I don't like to take some pictures of animals that exist in Brazil, which is in Africa. And, you know, I took a picture of some stuff, like chickens and etc. But I could not find the lizard, the one or the grandfather who did this to Abraham, so I can seek revenge. The funny, the Muslim, they say to us that the Quran said that nobody should pay for the sin of somebody else. Guys, don't they say that? I mean, why Jesus have to pay for your sin? Hello? Okay, hold on, Muslims. Did they say, for the sake of argument, cartoon story, right? Kid, 5 years old kid, the story, you won't believe this story, but we will go, we'll let it go. Let us say the grandfather of this idiot, he did blow wind at Abraham. Why you want to kill this kid? Into you Muslim, you say to us why nobody should pay for the sin of somebody else. And this is even in the Quran. So what is the logic of your prophet to kill the baby, the baby lizard of a grandfather? And I want you to prove to me, by the way, that this lizard really was involved in of burning Abraham. You know what? I'm going to try to capture a lizard, and I will try my best to have an interview with him. Lizard, why you did that? Why you are evil? How you do that? Shame on you. How I can respect you after now? You lizard did this to Prophet Abraham? Because the Prophet of Allah told us that there was nothing that not to try to extinguish the fire from Abraham, from all the animals, except this. So he told us to kill it. Someone want to call me? Let me see my Skype. Hold on. Well, I don't see anyone trying to call me. Well, give me your ID. If you are a Muslim only, you can call. No problem. How in the world this is, can be a prophet? And then look, Muhammad, he gave more details. Look at this. Except, and he ordered, forbid us from killing harmless snake except for the snake with two lions in its back and the snake with a short tail and for the snatch away the eyesight. And because, I mean, what is this? What is this? Test deep. Somebody asking me, Brazil in Africa, like, hold on, this is not the person, I put the wrong person. Okay, are you saying to me that I don't have knowledge in geography? Yes, Brazil in Africa. Any Muslim right now, he call me, he say something, he say, okay, Brazil in Africa, he will say you are a liar. If I say the prophet, he says so, he will say I agree. I mean, come on. From all the lies, it's in the screen. This is the only one make a problem for you. Come on, I'm really, Kim, I'm really upset from you. Like, come on, let it go. It's Brazil in Africa. You know, actually, let me tell you, like, Brazil, actually, it's not really in Africa. To be more accurate, I have to give you more details now. You put me in the corner. So I have to explain to you. You know, when I was last time in Somalia, and I crossed the river of Babylon in Somalia, and I was singing the song, in the river of Babylon, where we sit down. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, so anyway, I was in Somalia and I crossed the river of Babylon, which in Somalia. And then I found myself in Baghdad. Because, you know, Baghdad at that time, it was in Somalia too. You see, the problem, we are looking at the map today, which is changed by the kuffar. The kuffar changed it. I can show you from the Quran how the Quran and the hadith and the interpretation says that the Mediterranean Sea and the Persian Sea, they meet together. Don't ask me how. I mean, come on, let it go. Brazil is not Africa. Here we go. See, people are stubborn. They will not believe me. My friend, Brazil in Africa. All right, let us take this. You guys are crazy. Okay. Do we have any Muslims say anything? Did you find, look at this guy asking me a question. I mean, this is a fishy question. CP, did you find the murky pond at the sunset? And no, my friend, that is not in Somalia. That was in Al Bahrain. It's different location. Do we have any Muslim here when I explain to us how in the world you Muslims believe in this? By the way, the list is so long. We, you know, okay, what about Mickey Mouse? Do you know that Muslims, they have a fatwa, which means holy order to do jihad against Mickey Mouse? Mickey Mouse, by the way, say hello, he's fine. If you don't believe me, let me show you. This is one of the phobia of Islam and Muhammad. Mickey Mouse fatwa. Because some of you might not believe me, might think I'm making things up. No, my friend, I'm not. Here we go. Saudi cleric Muhammad al-Munjid, Mickey Mouse must die. Like, what the heck? Jihad on Tom and Jerry, fatwa issued. Like, what? Mickey Mouse must die? Yes, brother. Because Mickey Mouse is the enemy of Allah. And the Saudi, they were warning their children not to watch Mickey Mouse because that will make their children love the enemy of Allah. I mean, it makes sense. Don't tell me it doesn't make sense. I was wondering why I don't see Mickey Mouse in the TV no more. Since 2009, Mickey Mouse disappeared. He changed his name. I think now he called himself Mickey Prince, something like that, you know. He changed his name, and he is not going in the camera, and he is not doing live broadcast. And I mean, even Mickey Mouse is the enemy of Allah. Okay, this guy who is you are posting for me, he wanted to talk to me. Is he a Muslim? Is he a Muslim? Only Muslims, they are welcome to call me, at least for now. If you are a Muslim, we can call you in Skype. If not, then please don't waste my time. Do we have any Muslim would like to say anything? What this religion is about? Seriously, what this religion is about? How we can, in the year 2019, believe in such a cult? Anyone can tell me? What's wrong? To explain Quran chapter 654. Yeah, we can do that, but maybe a different time. As you see, we are busy now with the list of the phobia of the prophet. And by the way, this is remind me, I just come to my head. I mean, my head is like a small tiny library, brother. The same as was able to find that Brazil in Africa. I just remember something now, but I need to find the book. Once, guys, the Muslim, they fabricate stories. You can't even imagine. And this time it is a Shia story, the one I'm going to mention to you. A group of Christian monks, they come to Ali. Ali is the cousin of Muhammad, and he supposed to marry his daughter. And they ask him questions. Hold on, let me first find the story. I don't want to mention something like this without. Hold on. Where I can find the story now? I just remember it. As long as we are talking about animals and animals transformation. Where I can find this story now? Maybe I will not find it even in the internet. Okay. Maybe I can find it in English. Hold on. I think this will be impossible to find in English. No way. Anyway, to make the story short, a group of monks, they came. Hold on, I found something. Brother and sister, this is a true story. Okay, I'm going to open this link here and I'm going to use Google Translation so people will not say I'm making things up, because it's really crazy. Okay. قصص جميلة عن الإمام علي عليه السلام. Translation. Translate to English, brother. Okay. Beautiful stories about Imam Ali, peace be upon him. Let me make it smaller so we can have the story. Yeah, here we go. Bingo. You guys, today you will learn something amazing, something you never learned before. Once peace upon him. What does that mean? A Jew, here we go, a Jew, he came to him and he said to him, I want to ask you a question. Nobody can answer. And nobody can answer without even being disturbed. I mean, like, it's impossible to answer it without, and he's trying to disturb his prayer, obviously. So he said to him, this is a question nobody knows how to answer. I want to know what animals lay eggs and what animals lay give birth. So Ali, he said to him, this is easy. And then he said to him, the animals which lay eggs is the one who have their ears coming up. Those are the ones who give birth. And those who don't have ears coming up, they don't give birth. And this is, by the way, scientifically proven to be true, as you see in the story. The Google translation, by the way, is horrible, but I mean, this is what it says, what I can do. So as you see here, Ali, he shared the wisdom. Not only Muhammad, he knew, even the cousin, like, I mean, for sure you are the cousin of the prophet, so you will have a lot of knowledge too. And then second story, two men, they had a fight about a cow which killed a donkey. Then they said, those guys, they came to Ali and they said to him, what we will do, that this guy cow, he killed my donkey. So he said, Ali, okay, go to Abu Bakr. They went to Abu Bakr and Abu Bakr said, they said to him, an animal killed an animal, so what we shall do? Then he said, go and ask Umar. And Umar, he said, okay, I'm going to ask the Prophet. And then the Prophet said, go to Ali, which means all of those do not know what to do with this case. Abu Bakr and Umar and Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, they give up. That they don't know. I mean, cow, she killed a donkey. How they can solve the problem? They send it to Ali. And Ali said, if the cow entered the house of the donkey in his secure, safe area, then the guy should pay the value of the donkey. And if the donkey is the one who entered the house of the cow, then there is no penalty. But this is not really what I want to read for you. I'm just reading for you a collection of funny stories. I want to go to the animal story. Where is the animal story? About the monks. Where is the monks? Here we go. I think the fifth story. A group of monks entered the mosque of the Prophet, and they were carrying with them pieces of gold and jewelries. One of the monks, he said to Abu Bakr, you know, tell me something which nobody knows what it is. What is that which is not for Allah, and it is not with Allah, and Allah do not know? Abu Bakr, he said, I don't know what is that. Something it's not for Allah, and it's not with Allah, and Allah do not know. Then they decide to go to Umar. They are the same story. And then Umar, he give up too, just to make the story short. And then they went to Ali. They went to Uthman. They went to all of them, all the campaign of the Prophet. And then all of them, they have no answer. Then he went to the Imam Ali, the cousin of Muhammad. And they ask him the question. And you will not believe the answer. The answer is so good to be true. I don't know if the translation here will show you. To make it simple, the monk, after he listening to all those Muslim companions of the Prophet, he come to a decision that they are really big, but they are nothing. They are so proud about themselves, and they know nothing. And he decide to go back to his country. Then Salman al-Farisi, he run to Imam Ali, and he told him, and he asked him, please solve this issue. Imam Ali, he went with his two sons to the mosque. And the Muslims were so happy to see them coming, because nobody was able to answer the question. Abu Bakr, he said to the monk, here we come. We have the one who you are asking for, which means Ali. Ask whatever you want. And then the monk turned and asked him the same question, which he was asking the people before him. And he starts saying to him, Imam Ali, he said to him, what's your name? The guy, he said, my name is the monk asked the Imam, what's your name? And Ali, he said, my name for the Jews was Elia, and for Christ, Elijah, and for my father, Ali, and for my mother, Haydara. And then the monk, he asked him, and what is your relationship to the Prophet of Allah? He said, he is my brother and his cousin, and I am his son-in-law. The monk, he says, I swear by Isa, you are the one I am seeking. And he asked him the question, what is, I don't know if the translation in front of you is a little bit clear, what is the thing which is not Allah, and it is not with Allah, and Allah do not know it? Ali, he answered and he said, what is not Allah that Allah have no girlfriend and he have no son, and what is not from Allah that it's not the what it's called like non-just, and it is what is not, there's no partner with him, or let us say he's like answering the last one, trying to translate this funny story in English, and what is not from what is not with Allah is not to be just. The man, he said to him, that's amazing, you must be, you are the one. And then the monk, he decided that this is the person should be followed, and he decided to convert to Islam. Until now, actually, I'm trying to find the story. Oh, here we go. Okay, where is the story I was going to tell you? There's tons of stories here, but it's not the one I want to talk about. Let us see. I'm trying to find. Oh man. Wait. Don't tell me it's not in this page. All right, hold on. I found the story which I'm looking for. Really, I apologize because it's really confusing. This is a very long page, have tons of stories, and it's not really what I want. So we have to open another link. Here we go. And we click at a translate. It's unbelievable. Because I want you to see this. The story is about animals. The rest is not really important for me. Let us move. What the donkey he says when he is a brain? This is a question the monk is asking Ali. Those questions nobody knows the answer for them. Tell me what the dog is says when he is barking. Tell me what the donkey says when he is a brain. What the camel says when he in his desire. What does the crow says when he, etc. He make the sound. So all of those questions is about animals. What does the frog says in what the frog, a translation here is what he say when he like make the sound of a frog. Anyway, so all those questions about animals, what the frog say, what the rooster says, what the chicken says. And then Ali, he answer, he said, regarding the dog, where is the dog? As for the dog, he says, oh God, I'm deprived and you are merciful. Have mercy on those who you have mercy on me. I don't know what that means. As for the donkey, he says, God curse God what? The donkey says, Allah, he cursed those who take interest of the money, like borrow money. As for the camel, he says, I seek refuge by Allah, and Allah is my refuge. For the cow, she says, oh, who you are not aware of death, busy with some stuff. What you will happen when, like, what you will do when that day come, which means judgment day. And regarding the horse, he says, the female horse. When the female horse makes her sound, she says, may Allah bring victory to the Muslims and the believers. Regarding the chickens, what the chicken says, Ar-Rahman on his throne leveled. I mean, if I read, and then the story getting more exciting, and this is what actually what I wanted to show you. Look what we will find now. He asked him about following animals, how they became what they are. He said to him, tell me about, there is Allah, he did, I don't know what the word masakha in English. You see, when Allah, he made the Jews and monkeys and pigs, what is that called in English? In Arabic, we say masakha. Like he changed their situation from a human to animal. That's what masakha mean. So the man, the monkey, asked him, there's a 24 kind of women and men which Allah, he changed their situation into animals. Can he count them for me? Ali, he said yes. And he said, let us see. As for the elephant, there was a man who come to beast, which means he have sex with animals. So the elephant, he was a human being who used to have sex with animals. So Allah, he curse him and he make him an elephant. Makes sense, isn't it? Who in here don't agree with this? Wisdom, this is wisdom. As for the rabbit, it was a woman. The rabbit was what? The rabbit was a woman. She don't wash her private part after sex. So Allah, he made her a rabbit. After masturbation. And he asked him about the bear. Okay, and then he says, okay, what? And he said, the bear. The bear, my friend, he was a bad person who used to be, according to the story, a gay. So Allah make him a bear. As for the scorpion, oh boy, shall I continue? As for the scorpion, he used to be a person who speak in the back of people without knowing. So Allah, he cursed him and he made him a scorpion. All right, and then he continues saying, and regarding the pig, they used to be 700 men. As for the pig, they were 700 men. I don't know, guys, is the text clear from your side? You can read. Is the text clear? Let me know, please, if you can read. Is the text showing clear? So as for the pigs, they were 700 men who ate in the table of Isa, which they ate in the table of Jesus. Those are 700 men. They ate in the table of Jesus, the son of Maryam, peace be upon him, for 40 days and did not believe. Unbelievable. So now we know what the pigs used to be. The pigs, brother, they used to be 700 men who ate in the table of Isa, brother, for 40 days and they did not believe. So Allah made them pigs. Hello? Hello? As for the monkeys, they were 500 men of the Jews who walked in Sabbath. Like what? Thank God I found the story, because I remember the story, but I mean, how you see those stories cannot be found in English, you know. There's no way you can find them. Those are hilarious stories, and there's the Muslim will never translate this. So we have to use Google translation in order to show you. This is Islam, my friend. This is what they believe in. This is Islam. They say to you, Islam and science and madness, everything they say is nothing but the garbage. Continue. As for the spider, it was a woman. What? The spider was a woman? Yes, brother. It was a woman. Which is her husband? Unbelievable. And I was wondering why the spider, she have a different look. Why? It was a woman. She is doing witchcraft to her husband until he made her husband lose his mind. Not only that, even the turtle. Look, as for the turtle, it was a man. The turtle was a man who used to cheat in the scale. Like, you know, you buy 1 kilograms of tomato, he give you like one tomato less. So Allah curse him and he make him a turtle. Regarding the wizard. What about the lizard? Hey, hold on, before the lizard, where is hold on. Lizard. The lizard, he was a man who used to dig in the grave of people and he steal their clothing. Here the translation is not really coming good. Like here it says, this is the lizard. They call it here in translation, it's called the lump. He was a man, he dig in the graves, take the shrouds of the dead. As for the ladybug, yes, brother, she was a woman. The ladybug, she was a woman. I don't know how many of you do not. Anyone do not know what ladybug is? Let me find you, ladybug, brother. Ladybug. Because maybe some people they will not understand what ladybug is. This one. I mean, look at this. I was wondering what was this before. I never thought that this was a woman. Like what? This was a woman. Actually, look, yes, a lot of makeup, red, dark, eyelashes, sunglasses. I mean, isn't it obvious? Like hello, hello. I mean, why you cannot see it? Why you cannot see it? It's very clear. Look at this: high heels, shoes, red coat, expensive style, flashy. You know, she likes to show off. All right. I mean, look, lipstick, ladybug. Thank you. Somebody said ladybug is a lady. Even the name confirmed that. Look, hold on. Who is? Well, it's a lady. John Wick, even his name is John Wick. I mean, look at this. It is a lady, ladybug. Oh, boy. Maybe it's funny, but it's sad. It's really sad that in the year 2019, there's people that believe in this madness. Isn't it sad? Let us continue. The other one. Where is the other one? All right. So the ladybug, she was a woman who she asked the husband of her daughter to sleep with her. How ugly. Now he go to the crab. Regarding the crab, you know the crab, right? He was a man married to two women. Okay. And he used to like one more than the other, which Muhammad, that's mean Muhammad was a crab too, because Muhammad, he said he, the most favorite woman he like is Aisha. As for the fox, he was a man who was a thief. He steal. Guys, look at the wisdom here. I don't know how, if you can see how deep this is. This is a fox. He was a man who is a thief. So he was a thief as a man, still he is a thief as an animal. And he used to steal the stuff of the people who doing Hajj every year. This man, he steal the things of the those who do Hajj. Look at this. And now he go to something else. Hornet. I don't know how many of you knows what hornet is. Let us try to find the picture. Hornet. Where is the hornet? Okay, let us find the hornet. Oh boy. Actually, this is not the one. Is it hornet? This is not the correct translation. You know, the boar is the big, like the same as the bees, but it's the one who killed the bees, really. Maybe this one. Yeah. So this one, what he was. You will not believe it, my friend. The hornet, it was a man who accused the scholars of lying.
If.
So now a Christian prince, he will wake up tomorrow, he will find himself a hornet.
Unbelievable.
Guys, I don't know. I feel like when I talk to you, I want to say what happened? I cannot talk. What? This is what happened to the one who accused the scholars of lying? This is what happened? That's deep. That is deep, and that is science, and that is must be from God. This knowledge nobody knows. Nobody knows, my friend. This is absolutely true. Well, come on, are you kidding me? How Ali, he knew this? How he knew this? There's no way. It's God who taught him. Absolutely. Okay. And then, see, he was a man accusing the scholars of lying. This is Google translation. As for the dog, okay, what about the dog? He was a man testifying falsehood. I'm going to die soon. Let me, hold on. The dog, he was a man, and he was testifying. Shame on you. No wonder you are hiding behind the couch. And I was saying to myself, why is he hiding? Why he put his head there? It's obvious. He feel guilty. The dog was a man who is false. He go to the court. I swear by Allah, I'm going to say the truth. And then he starts saying lying about the story. And Allah curse him, and he made him a dog. True story. Kuffar, drinking alcohol. Isn't it obvious? You can't trust a dog. They lie. They drink alcohol and they lie. I'm going to have heart attack, guys. I should stop doing podcast. This is really too much. Guys, Guys, the Muslims doing competition to give me dislike, and you guys, you don't care. The Muslim gave me already 40 dislike. I don't know why. I'm just reading your books. What's wrong? 40 dislike from the Muslims. Where is the Christians? Where is the Hindus? Where is the Buddhas? So this dog, he was a man. Look, he was drinking beer and and lying in the court. He woke up in the morning. He found himself a dog. Look, he went to the court. He took false witnesses in the court. And he came back. He took a shower. He put a beer in his lap. And he took a nap. He woke up. He found himself a dog. Unbelievable. True story. I was wondering what, like, oh boy. This is religion. All right. And then Venus. What? Venus? Yes, brother, Venus. You know what Venus, right? This is not alcohol. I'm not expert, sorry. somebody corrected me saying, sorry, this is not alcohol. I don't know what it is. What it is? Hold on, what is that? Let me make it big. We need to investigate. Somebody say this is not alcohol. This is what? What is that? This is water? This is mineral water? That make it more horrible even. That's mineral. You know, for us, I'm an Arab, so for us, anything is inside the ball, it's alcohol. Anyway, let it go. And how in the world you put water inside the glass? I mean, what is that? And by the way, you guys, do you buy this this madness, mineral water? Do you believe it really? It's they are fooling you. What mineral water? Mineral water. Well, if people believe Muhammad, why they will not believe the mineral water will make you better healthy? Yeah, right. Anyway, spend your money as you wish. Let us go back to the story. Who care about the mineral water now? Okay, Venus. Okay, who was Venus? Venus was a woman. If. Venus. Where we will find Venus now here? Oh, here we go. We found Venus. Oh boy, I cannot look. It's haram. I cannot look at this. Excuse me. This is Venus. Let me, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you Venus. I think I should have changed this picture. It's not healthy. Let us go back to the mineral water. I think that is more secure and safe. I mean, what mineral water is better? Where is the mineral water? Here we go. I don't want to look at Venus, man. That's crazy. We stay with the mineral water. How many of you hate me? Be honest. So why I have only 981 like? What's wrong? You see, yesterday we have 2,000 people watching. Today we have less. Why? Because I think I need to do broadcast once a week, so you miss me more. Isn't it? Yeah. Anyway, by the way, tomorrow I think I will do broadcast in my other channel, so you can watch me there. The quality of life, if you like to join us. But it's not going to be about religion. It's going to be about something else. So as you see, those stories, this is what the Muslims believe in. I mean, how in the world this can be? And here, by the way, it says Marut was tempted by the great by her. So that the Muslim believe that there is an angel, his name is Harut and Marut. And this is mentioned in the Quran. He was sent down to earth and they opened Harry Potter school. If you remember, let's go to the Quran. And if you go and read the interpretation of this verse, you will see that the Muslims believe that Harut and Marut both were angels. Were tempted by a woman, her name is Venus. And Venus, she made a condition in order to take off her panty for them. They have to tell her the password to go to heaven. So they did, told her the password. And when Allah, he learned that she is coming up to heaven, Allah, he cursed her and he made her Venus. All right. My other channel, maybe the admin can post it for you. It's called the Quality of Life 27. Please call Muslim. Okay, where is the Muslim to call? Did you find me a Muslim to call? Draw Rangel, go up. Skype ID is there. I don't know. Where is the Muslim? Any Muslim want to call me? We want Muslims. Is he a Muslim? Don't give me just an ID of somebody. If he is a Muslim, we will call him. If not, no. Anyone? This guy, G-H-E, he's a Muslim? Okay, let us see, Mr. G. All right. Well, it doesn't sound like he's a Muslim. I don't know. Let us see. Let me give him a chance. I did text you, Mr. G. It doesn't show that you are online. Are you there? Let us call him too. It says he is not even online. I have no time for this. All right. Any Muslim would like to call us? Mr. Leonardo, are you a Muslim? We want only Muslims to call us. Are you a Muslim? I will leave that to the admins to check those who they claim they want to call me, to check if they are Muslims, and then if they approve that, then we will go for it. As you see, Islam is nothing but collections of superstitions, fabrications, madness, racism. Black dog is the devil. Lizard is the enemy of Allah. Lizard tried to kill Abraham. I mean, endless madness. And there is no way anyone, he have, you know, little education. I mean, those stories maybe were acceptable for ignorant people who live in the desert 1,000 years ago. But how in the world, you today in 2019, you believe in such a thing? How in the world today, you believe that God, he sent angels to open a school to teach Harry Potter skills? Allah sent two angels and they land in the Babylon Tower, as you see. And they open a school, and before you join the school or the classroom, they make you sign a disclaimer that you agree that you will not use this except to make the man and the wife fight. I mean, have you ever heard of a God? He opened a school to teach magic, and the purpose of this school, to make the man and the wife fight. Somebody saying to me, Muslim Qasim, he's saying, are you limiting God? No, I'm not limiting God. You are the one who limit God. because you just made God an idiot. It's not me who is limiting God, it's you. What this is a God, he will send two angels to open a school to teach you how to make a man and the wife fight. Do you really believe in that, what you said, Mr. Qasim? Are you limiting God? Allah is not strong, and we can prove it easy, because obviously the one who have such a story, he don't have a strong brain. The one who created the universe, the one who told us how Allah, he said to you, supposedly you claim Muslims, that you should be nice to your wife and your wife should be obeying you, and then Allah, he opened a school of evil, because this is a school of evil. Correct, people? When Allah, he opened a school, and the purpose of the school to divide the wife and the husband from their marriage, to divorce, to fight, who is the one who opened the school? Allah. This is a school of evil. So Allah, he sent two angels to do special schooling by using magic, which is proven to be false. Magic, what magic? Even your prophet, he taught you. You say that Allah is strong, right? Okay. Well, isn't it the prophet and you Muslims believe that your prophet was under the influence of magic? Where is Allah the strong? Allah, he promised to protect Muhammad, and Muhammad died by poison and he was affected by magic. He sent angels as test, and whenever learned the magic, we are told if you learn magic, you have, then you have disbelief. This is was the test. So I am God, I send angels, and I say to you, if you learn magic, and the purpose of the magic, if you learn magic, you disbelieve. By the way, it doesn't say that. You are obviously, you have no idea, and you do not know what the Quran is saying. You are ignorant like your prophet. If you go to the verse, you will see it is not talking about whoever do magic is disbelieving, because the angels themselves are doing the magic. Because if doing the magic is making you disbelieve, that's mean Harut and Marut, they disbelieve themselves, because they are the one not only doing magic, they are teaching it. Secondly, neither those two angels taught anyone such a thing till they had said, we are only a trial, so disbelieve not. They bit between two brackets by learning this magic from us. And from those angels, people learned by which they cause separation between the man and the wife. Okay, so we are a trial, so disbelieve not. And they put falsely between two brackets by learning magic from us. This is not true. Learning magic will not make you disbelieve, because simply, it's a practice in the magic will make you disbelieve. Learning the magic is just learning. I can learn, but don't practice it. I can learn how to kill, but I don't kill. Killing will make me not innocent no more, but learning something will not. So here the God, he sent two angels, and the purpose of him sending them, look what he sent them. He sent them in the Babylon tower. Fiction story. And then those two angels, when they went to down to earth, they met a woman, her name is Venus. And they asked her to sleep with him, with them. And Venus, she said to them, I will not sleep with you unless you tell me, unless you do a few things, and you tell me the password of heaven. Is that true, Mr. Qasim? Or I'm making things up? Is that true? Any Muslim want to say I'm lying? That is what you Muslims believe? That the two angels, they had sex with the woman, her name is Venus, and Allah, he cursed her and he made her a planet? Anyone? We can go right now to the interpretation. And you will die laughing. You took stories from the people in the street from the old days and you put it in the Quran. Okay. Let us see. Mr. Qasim, he is saying a reference. So we have to give him reference. Give me a second. You know, he's right. We need reference. Let us find him the reference. All right. Did he say he want reference, guys? This is Al-Islam website. This is alislam.org. This is not Christian Prince. Let us see the story of Harut and Marut. All right, it says Ali was giving a sermon from etc. blah 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 blah. It says, and he said to us, he read to us, the star is Venus. Once Allah Almighty, he made angels see the conditions of a human being who were busy disobeying Allah. The angels named Harut and Marut said, there are people whose great grandfather Adam was one of them, one of whom you had created you by your hand. And it was so. Anyway, read the story. And then he says, this is a star. Her name is Venus. In Arabic is Az-Zuhra. Was a very beautiful woman. She had gone to one of those two angels obtaining some kind of decision. At the very first sight of her, that angel fell in love with her, and he told her that that truth is with you and my judgment will be in your favor. Anyway, so here and then the story continue. They wanted to have sex with her. Look, when both of the angels reached Venus at the appointed time and saw one another, their heads bowed in shame, because each one of them, he was trying to date this woman to sleep with her, but she did not tell them both that she would sleep with both. So now she made them meet, and both of them, they became ashamed. But anyway, so the story here continue. I have come here for the same purpose which you have come. Both asked the women to allow them to have sex with her. She made them prostrate before her idols and made them drink wine and get the beggar to be killed. The story is long, but the story simply is saying that Venus, she made the two angels have boom boom with her because she is so sexy, and you know it. Are you still asking me for reference, Mr. Muhammad Qasim? Do you want more reference? This is your reference. And then they told her the password to heaven. And when she went up to heaven, Allah, he cursed her and he made her Venus. Who else? Don't challenge Christian Prince and say reference. You know you are talking to someone. He don't say things unless he is sure. Right? Must be authentic or nothing authentic in Islam. Here we go, guys. Must be authentic. A Muslim is giving us a great example of the non-authentic religion. This is a non-authentic religion. Each time we tell the Muslim a story, they say it must be authentic. What is authentic in Islam? Nothing. Nothing. And you are telling me must be authentic. Tell you to yourself why you have it in your books. And why you explain the Quran by it if it's not authentic? So you Muslims explain the Quran by telling a lie? Are you telling me that? He's telling us you cannot trust Muslims. If Muslim told you something about Islam, don't trust them. This is what Mr. Qasim is saying to us. If a Muslim, he told you something about Allah, about Islam, he is not telling the truth. It's not authentic. Because nothing authentic in Islam. This is what you are saying. Thank you very much. And as long you are talking about authentic, was it authentic, the story of Abraham and the lizard trying to burn him? Was it authentic in the Quran, the story of the flying carpet of Suleiman? Was authentic the story of the Hudhud who tried to find women to Suleiman? Was the story of the ant telling the ant to hide it from Suleiman is an authentic story? This is Quran. Authentic. The easiest way to run away from reality, to say, oh, it must be authentic. I agree with you. Nothing in Islam is authentic. All is fake. All is lie. Is it authentic that God, he sent two angels to teach magic? Where is the proof of that? As long as you are talking about authentic. Okay, what is the proof of that? How angels, they are sent to teach magic? And where? In the Babylon. Why in the Babylon? Yeah, it's a miracle. Guys, it's a miracle. It's a miracle. This is a miracle. It's a miracle that Suleiman, he have a genie and shaitan, they die for him. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Who is going to believe in this? Flying carpet, shaitan, they work for Suleiman and they dive for him in the ocean to bring him jewels. Who is going to believe in this stupid story? And then some of the shaitan, because they disobey Suleiman, he put them in jail. Who want to debate on Islam with me? Who are you? Are you a Muslim, my friend? The one who's saying he want to debate in Islam with me, Mr. Paranormal. Paranormal. Are you a Muslim? Who wanna call us to explain to us what is this? Hey, Panoramal, we ask you, are you a Muslim? Who wanna debate with Islam about me? Okay, I will debate with Islam with you. Are you a Muslim? This guy is copy paste. Okay, we will debate about Islam with you, but are you a Muslim first? The qualification to join a debate with the Christian prince, at least to be a Muslim. Are you a Muslim? Please don't insult anyone, insult Muslims. We are going to block you. Be careful. Here we are seeking debate and a nice talk, not insult to anyone. Anyone? You are an imam? Really, you are an imam? Give me your Facebook imam page. This guy is an imam. give me your Facebook. Let us see how imam you are. Any Muslim, he have a knowledge to call us? As you see, this religion is full of fictions, crazy stories. Nothing there makes sense, as usual. The black dog is the devil. The lizard tried to kill Abraham. This is what it is, what we can say. This is what it is. And as you see, Muslims have no answer. Red Admiral, he is a criticizing angels in Islam, so I'm asking for proof too. Well, I'm not a creator. It's you. You see, when you bring me a story, you bring me the proof. You have one guy, he have no witnesses, nobody heard him, nobody. This guy is saying to us a story, claiming that God told him this. What is the proof? This is what's funny about Muslim. They said you authentic. What authentic? Your prophet himself has no witnesses for anything he said. He speak about Moses, he never saw Moses. He never exists in the time of Moses, but yet he's telling you what happened with Moses. As an example, when Muhammad, he speak about Moses was chasing a stone. Where Muhammad he got this story from? He was there. A stone, she stole the clothing of Moses. And Moses, he chased the stone and he started beating the stone. And as you see, this is a very authentic story. So what we would do? Where is the witnesses for Muhammad for his story? How come you did not ask your prophet to give you an authentic source? Where is the source? Read the story with me. Allah Messenger. Maybe we have a Muslim. Let us see. Mr. Guidance, you can contact me if you like. Feel free. I'm very hungry. I don't know if you can hear my stomach is talking. Allah Messenger said, Moses was a shy person and used to cover his body completely because of his extensive shyness. One of the children of Israel heard him by saying he covered his body because he have a defect in his skin. Actually, they are talking about something he have in his balls. And look what happened. Moses, when he take a shower, he go in seclusion. Like he don't like people to see him. He's shy. He took off his clothes and put them on a stone and start taking a bath. Then he had finished the bath. He moved toward his clothes as to take them. But the stone took the clothes and fled. Moses picked up his stick and ran after the stone, saying, "Oh stone, give me my garment," till he reached the group of Bani Israel. So the story is very simple. Moses taking a shower. He put his clothes, taking a bath. He put his clothes in a stone. The stone stole his clothes. Mr. Qasim, can you give me the source for this? This is authentic story. You cannot tell me this is a lie. You tell me where Muhammad get this story from. A stone is stealing the clothes of Moses. And now Moses is running naked downtown after the stone, speaking to the stone, saying, "Stone, give me my clothes." This is authentic. You see, this is authentic. This is Sahih al-Bukhari. Is Sahih al-Bukhari authentic? What you will say? Even the cat is laughing. This is authentic. Aren't you the one who's asking me for authentic? We have a Muslim, let us see. Well, he's not answering. Is the call declined? So why you are begging us to talk to us and add you in Skype and I want to talk to you and then we call you, you don't answer. The call declined. So what this drama was for? We thought we got like a... All right. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, my friend. You're live on air. Mr. Guidance.
Yeah.
Your voice is not good, my friend. Say again, what?
Can I speak? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. You are live on air and people, they can hear you. Go ahead. What do you want to say?
Yeah, fine. I have only one question for you. All right. Mr. Christian Prince. So the whole Christian community thinks that Jesus is God, right?
What do you say, Jesus is God?
Right.
You think Jesus is God?
What?
Do you think Jesus is God?
I don't think Jesus is God.
Why he's not God?
Yeah, the main reason why he's God.
Why he's not God?
Because he was sent by someone.
Who is the one who sent him?
In the sky.
Who is the one who sent him?
God sent him.
Okay.
God sent him.
All right. So let me ask you now. If somebody was sent by someone, we are having a conversation. Hold on, we are having a conversation. If somebody was sent by somebody, that body he cannot, that person cannot be God. Do you agree?
No.
If someone was sent by someone, he cannot be God. Do you agree?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. That's me. Okay. Who is the one who sent messengers? Only God or someone else?
God sent the messengers.
Okay, how you explain to me in the Quran chapter 36 that the Messiah, he sent the three messengers and they are the messengers of God?
Yeah.
Hmm.
They are sent by God.
No, so they are sent by the Messiah. They are sent by the Messiah. It's by God. By the Messiah. All you Muslims agree that those are three messengers. Mm-hmm. They are the messengers of the Messiah. How the Messiah...
Can you give me the number?
Yeah, sure. Chapter number 36. Verse number 14. You can read from verse number 12, 13, 14. It's up to you.
One second, let me check it. Yeah, chapter number what, please?
Chapter 36. You can read it from verse, anyway, you can read from verse number 1 if you want, but you can start from verse number 13.
Mm-hmm. Okay, chapter 36, verse number 14.
Verse number 13, 14, 15. Read as you wish. You can read 10 verses before and 20 verses after, as you wish.
The chapter 36 verse number 40 reads
14.
That was messenger sent by
by who?
And God sent
by who?
Yeah,
by who?
And we sent them to messengers.
By who?
It is God who sent.
Okay, it's God who sent them. Thank you, guys. Did he say God sent them? Did he say, did our friend here, what? Did he agree that the one who sent those messengers is God? That is Jesus, my friend. The story here is about the three messengers. One of them is John.
Yeah.
The other one is Paul. And the third one is Peter. Three messengers are the messenger of God. You just say that the one who sent them is God. But those are the disciples of Jesus, sent by Jesus.
The Quran doesn't mention that it was sent by Paul.
No, my friend. Someone. No. It says it clearly. When we sent to them two messengers, they believe. Okay. Who is the one who sent the two messengers? Yeah.
It's sent by God.
Okay. Can you name for me those messengers who sent by God?
No, it's said we sent them two messengers.
No problem. Who are they? Those two messengers? Can you name them for me? So we can find out who are those
messengers, because it's not mentioned in the Quran.
No, it's mentioned, my friend. It's mentioned. If you go, because nothing mentioned in the Quran anyway. If you go
in the tafsir,
who is the one?
It's not mentioned.
According to tafsir, what? Who is the one who sent them? According to tafsir.
I don't know according to tafsir who sent, but
okay. According to tafsir, my friend.
It was reinforced by third,
my friend. According to tafsir, Are you going to let me talk? Just hold on. According to tafsir, who are those messengers? According to tafsir,
I don't know. According to tafsir, who was sent? You want me to check it now?
I can check it for you. Here we go. I will put it for you in the screen. According to tafsir, those are three messengers, and they are the messengers of Jesus the Christ.
Yeah, it might be. It might have been, for example, God will command Jesus to send them. That could also be.
Hold on, no, you are the one who sent to me. Jesus cannot be God because he was sent by someone. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But how Jesus is not God, but he can send messengers and he make you a prophet, because those are became messengers and they are doing miracles. Even they made a human being come back from death.
No, Mr. Christian, let me clear you.
Okay.
Those two, you're saying that those two messengers were sent by Jesus, right?
I'm not saying that. It's you Muslims saying that.
No, it was sent by God, because to
my friend, it's not me who is saying that. My friend, do you understand me? It's not me who said that.
It is
you Muslim saying that those are the messengers of Jesus, and they were sent to the city of Antioch. And this is true. The city of Antioch is the first city to become a Christian.
Yeah, it might be.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
it might be.
Who are
God
they? Who
Jesus
are they?
Okay. Them.
Fine. Who are they? Those messengers who sent to the city of Antioch. Can you give me their names?
I don't know who I don't exactly.
Well, like, here we go. In front of me, it says the name of the first two messengers were Shamun, which means Simon Peter, and the second is Johanna, which means John, and the third is Paulus,
yeah,
which means Paul. Okay,
yeah, it might be.
But okay, but Paul, you Muslims, you keep attacking Paul, and John is disciple of Jesus, and Peter,
yeah.
Simon Peter is disciple of Jesus. He never spoke to Allah. They never met Allah, and they are not messenger of Allah. Yeah, they are messenger of Jesus. The Quran claim that those are messengers of God.
Yeah, they are messengers of God.
Okay, how they can be? How they can be messenger of God is the one if the one who gave them orders is Jesus.
See, for example, I send my cousin to guide someone. Okay, so if my cousin sends me, that doesn't mean that it is me. It's my cousin. See, that cousin doesn't have my status. So same way, God might have told Jesus.
No, but you cannot send.
So it doesn't mean
can Muhammad send? Okay, hold on. Can Muhammad make you a prophet or a messenger of God? Do he have authority to make you a messenger of God?
What?
Can Muhammad make you a messenger of God?
No, he cannot make me
okay.
a messenger.
So how Jesus, how Jesus the Christ, my friend, listen. How Jesus, he was able to make Shamaun or Simon, Peter, and Johanna and John, and Paulus or Paul as messengers.
To send the message.
No, he did not only send them. Look, read the story. The Quran confirmed that those are messengers of God. This is number one. Number two, they made miracles. They made miracles. Did they make miracles? Did they make people come to life?
No, they didn't do any miracles.
Huh? What?
Quran doesn't say that they do miracles.
What are you talking about?
They didn't say any miracles in this Quran. Where did they say?
It doesn't say that.
They said. Obey those who ask no wages for you and who are rightly guided. And people ask, and they say, why should I worship? Why not worship him who has created me and to whom I shall be returned? Should I? They are asking.
So you are saying the verses there does not say that they did miracles. Are you saying that?
Yeah, they didn't do any miracles. What miracles they did? Tell me. Name
okay,
any
read,
single miracle.
Okay, read from verse number 17. Verse number 18, verse number 19.
17?
Yeah.
What is that? Yeah, 17 says, our duty is to convey plainly the message of God.
And?
They didn't do any miracles.
They did not do any miracles. So you Muslims are lying.
They didn't do any miracles, but
are you sure that they did not do any miracles? I'm asking you for the last time. Are you sure that they did not do any miracles?
No, they didn't do any miracles.
Okay. Can you read the interpretation for me of the verses?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you read the interpretation? What interpretation you are reading from? You are saying they did not do miracles. This is not what the Muslims believe.
Sir, in this specific text from Surah Yasin, it said those messengers were sent to the prophets.
No problem. This is not what I'm asking. Did they do miracles? Yes or no? Hold on.
No, they didn't.
You said they did not do miracles, correct? What interpretation you are reading from?
What? No, they didn't do any miracles.
Okay, how you know they did not do miracles? Okay, hold on. When the Quran says we send the third to string them. Okay, hold on. When the Quran said we send the third to string them, what the third did?
Yeah.
Okay, what those the third person, did? What the third did?
The person, they said, verily we have been sent to you as a messengers.
Okay, what the third did? What he did? What he did?
He didn't say anything. He just went along with those
my friend, it says
the people.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did they come to them with a clear proof?
We have been sent
did they
to
come?
Messengers.
Did they come with the proof? Did Allah send them with signs? Yes or no?
What?
Did Allah send them with signs or without signs?
Yeah, show me where is that verse.
So you are saying he did not send them with signs? Yes or no?
No, they didn't send them with signs.
Okay, guys, he said
they
did
not normal people.
Okay,
they are normal people.
To convey okay, read for me verse number 12.
Okay. 12, we give life to the dead and record what they have sent before the trace, and everything is recorded in numbers.
Okay, apologize for lying to me. Yeah. You repeat it. You see, I spent 15 minutes trying to be sure that you are not making a mistake. I asked you what interpretation you are reading. I asked you what book you are reading from. And you keep saying they did not do miracles. But the verse in front of you saying, we give life to the dead. Does it say that?
Yeah, it's God who is saying to...
Listen. It is you who said to me, I asked you, did those messengers, guys, did I ask this guy, this gentleman, did those messengers did any miracles? I even told you they brought people to life. You said no. You said no. You said to me, show me where it says that. You see, the Muslim, they play games, and I like to play it with them. I was playing with you. So all this time, you consistently saying they did not do any miracle. Why you did lie to me? Did they raise people from the dead? Did they raise people from the dead? Okay, hold on. No. Why you lie to me? It says, listen, you said Allah made me. Look, it says we give life to the dead. Guys, did they say? Verily.
Yeah.
We give. Okay.
Yeah.
Who are those who give life to the dead?
We it means God. God is like we give life to the
and
dead.
This miracle
like
was given to who?
Saying,
and this miracle, hold on. Read the story. You
example,
are being hypocrite. We are being hypocrite.
Yeah, for example,
very we okay. Hold on. Allah, He sent those messengers, and Allah, He gave them miracles. They can raise people from death. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay, so why you said to me, so why you said to me, why you said to me they did not do miracles?
They didn't do it. It's not they who did miracles. That their story.
Are you an Ahmadiyya? Are you an Ahmadiyya? Are you an Ahmadiyya?
Sir, their story.
I'm asking you. Are you an Ahmadiyya? Are you? Why you don't want to answer? Are you an Ahmadiyya?
What, sir?
Are you an Ahmadiyya?
No, I'm a Muslim.
What Muslim? What is your religion? Muslim what?
I'm just a Muslim.
No, there's nothing called a Muslim. Even your prophet, he said there's no such a thing.
Quran.
You're a prophet. You are what?
What? Follow what the prophet said and what Quran says.
Thank you, guys. Did he say that we follow what the prophet said? So if I show you what the prophet said, are you going to admit that those are the messengers of Jesus and they did miracles?
They didn't do miracles, sir. Let me make it very clear. The story of the two sir, don't laugh.
Okay.
The story
well, because
of those
you are funny,
messengers.
I just showed you the interpretation.
So before that,
the interpretation, the story,
no
all of them, they
like
admit
those
that
people,
those are people
those
who did miracles.
True.
Okay. Are you a Muslim Sunni?
Yeah, I'm a Muslim Sunni. Yeah,
okay.
Sir, he said.
Okay, hold on.
The main reason I
okay,
want to talk,
he said he is
no,
a Muslim
sir,
Sunni. No, no. Don't tell me the reason. Don't tell me the reason. I know the reason. I know the reason. I just showed you that messengers of Jesus, they are messengers of God. So your God, who came 600 years after Jesus, is stealing the names of the apostle of Jesus, claiming that those are His messengers. So who is the thief?
It's not thieves. Messengers can be anyone who.
No, they cannot.
Messages.
Those are messengers of Jesus, my friend.
That's what happened.
Simon Peter and Thomas and John and Paul. Those are messengers of Jesus, and they did miracles in the name of Jesus. So how Allah? Okay, hold on. How Allah? He take the messenger of Jesus. He put them in His book.
What?
How the messenger of Jesus became the messenger of Allah? Explain to me.
How Jesus became the messenger, you're asking me?
No. How the messengers of Jesus became the messengers of Allah?
It said that God sent them two messengers.
Thank
it
you very much. God, He sent
anyone.
Them. Guys, did He say God
example,
sent them?
God
thank you.
Them.
You just said God,
example,
He sent them. Guys, he just said, God, He sent them.
Example,
okay, thank you. Okay, God, He sent them, my friend. God,
example,
God, He sent them.
I'm a prophet. Okay.
Who
so
is the
God
one who sent them?
Me to send someone.
Listen.
So
who is the one? Who is the one who sent them? God.
God.
That is Jesus. How Jesus is not God, but yes, he sent them.
No, God. Yeah, God doesn't have.
Okay, I want you in front of everybody. I want you in front of everybody. You claim to be a Muslim Sunni. Listen. You are just trying to talk over me. Just to not to answer. Give me an Islamic Sunni. Refuse to accept. Give me an Islamic Sunni interpretation. Refuse to accept that those are messengers of Jesus. Can you?
So it could be companions of Jesus, messengers of Jesus, but it was directly sent by God. You mean?
No, they cannot be sent directly by God because they did not speak to Allah. Did Allah speak to those messengers? Did Allah speak to those messengers?
No,
who is the one? Okay, then who is the one? Who is the one who gave them the orders to go to the city of Antioch? Who is the one who gave them the orders to go to the city of Antioch?
Muhammad was sent. God said, "I sent Muhammad." But the message was conveyed through. He didn't say.
Okay, let me ask you just to show you the theft in the Quran. Let me ask you, Allah, He sent those three messengers to which city? To which city?
Yeah.
To which city? Yeah. Where? Did he send them where? Allah, he sent them.
Antioch. Right?
Antioch. Yeah. Guys, did he say Antioch? Okay, what is the language of the city of Antioch?
I don't know what language.
They are Aramaic.
Okay,
the city of Antioch, at that time, there's Aramaic and there is a Greek people there. Hold on. There's Aramaic and there's a Greek. Okay, how are you Muslim? You say that Jesus was a messenger to the Jews, yet the messengers of Allah sent by Jesus is sent to Antioch, which is not a city of the Jews, and there's not a single Jew there.
God can send anyone anywhere.
My friend, don't tell me God
sent. There's no boundary. There's no limit.
You just admitted that those are the messengers of Jesus. So how Jesus is a messenger for the Jews? Yet he sent his messengers to the city of Antioch.
Sir, you're really confusing. It said by we have sent messages. It's like God had sent.
This is not the question. Listen, Jesus, if Jesus was sent to the Jews, is the Jews? Who is the one is confused? Is you? Who is the one is confused? You Muslim, you keep saying Jesus is not God. He was sent only to the Jews. And now we find that Jesus, he sent his messenger to the city of Antioch. Is Antioch is the city of the Jews?
I don't know about that. I didn't.
You don't know nothing. Anything. Look what you do. Anything is embarrassing to you as a Muslim. You say, I do not know. I ask you, what is the name of those three messengers? You said, I do not know. I asked you what city. You said, I do not know. Jesus was a messenger for the Jews or for the city of Antioch. Suddenly you said, I don't know. Anything is embarrassing. You say, I don't know. Okay, let me make it more simple to you. I will make it very simple. If I am a messenger, do I have an authority? If I am a messenger, I have an authority. What is the highest authority I have as a messenger? Can I make you as a messenger of God if I'm a messenger?
Well, I get the question.
Okay, let us say you are Muhammad, the prophet of Islam. Hello? And I am one of your friends. Can you make me a messenger of Allah?
No, I cannot make you.
Okay, so how Jesus he sent those three messengers and he made them messengers of God? If he is just, he cannot, he is a messenger too.
Yeah, it doesn't say they are the prophet. It said that there's a messenger. It could be anyone.
I just asked you a second ago. I did not ask you to. I said to you. Listen.
Doesn't mean
I did not say a prophet. And by the way, how you can be a messenger and you are not a prophet? This is the most stupid thing in Islam. How you can be a messenger but you are not a prophet?
No, there's a difference between messenger How is and that? Prophet.
Okay, name for me. Name for me one person. Okay, name for me. Okay, name for me one messenger. He is not a prophet.
There are many prophets.
Give me one. Give me one. Give me one. Don't tell me there is many. Give me one. One messenger. Mm-hmm. He is a messenger of Allah, but he's not a prophet. Give me one.
Yeah, these three messengers.
What do you mean those three messengers? Give me their name. How he can be a messenger? Okay, what is the message? Is the message from Allah? The messengers, did they deliver? Hold on. Did the messengers deliver a message from Allah? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. God said, is it the message from Allah is a prophecy? You see, listen, listen. The message of Allah, do anyone else knows beside Allah what Allah will say? Or only Allah knows?
So it could be that God had
this is not a question. This is not a question. This is not a question. When Allah He said things to those messengers, Allah He sent those. Listen, listen. Allah He sent those messengers. He sent them with message. Did He?
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
Is this message known to those people or it's unknown?
It's unknown to.
Thank you. That this is the prophecy. So because when you speak of the unknown, don't call me again, please. Let your scholar call me.
No, no, no.
No kids. No kids. Listen. Don't waste my time. This is stupid. You are stupid. When you say there is a messenger, but he is not a prophet, but he is delivering a message which nobody knows, don't call me. I don't have time for kids. Don't call me. That's it. Don't even try. You just said you deliver a message of unknown message. That is a prophecy. Prophecy is telling what God said, what God want. This is a prophecy. Prophesying of God. Prophet is someone who deliver what God he will do. He told them judgment day is coming. This is a prophecy. If you don't believe this will happen to you, this is a prophecy. God will destroy you. This is a prophecy. So how they can be messengers but they are not prophet? This is stupid. This is one of the stupid things in the cult of Islam. And they say to you, Jesus cannot be God because he was sent by someone. Well, Allah was sent by someone too. Allah himself, he claimed, or the Muslims claim, that he created himself from the sweat of the horse. So Allah one day was a horse. And then he became a sweat. And then he became Allah. It's your claim. It's your claim that Jesus is not God, but you cannot prove it. Allah cannot be God. Allah says stupid things, stupid history, stupid science, stupid madness. I will give you a chance. I will call you again. You know, I'm losing my patience with you. But I want you to be honest. A messenger who deliver a message of God which nobody knows save God is a prophet, for he's prophesying of what God will do to us. Our duty only to convey to you what? Prophecy. The message of God is a prophecy. What will happen to you? You will be punished if you don't believe. This is the message. Okay, I will call you again. I will give you a last chance.
Hello, Mr. Christian Prince.
Go ahead.
Safety and peace be upon you.
Sorry?
Safety and peace be upon you. Safety and peace be upon you. Sir, I had to ask you only one single question, okay? Mm. Okay.
Go ahead.
The question is, who knows the knowledge of the hour or the knowledge of the day of judgment? Who knows that?
Jesus. The Bible says, Jesus, he said, that no one, no son of a man, nobody knows except the Father. And Jesus says, me and the Father is one.
No, Jesus specifically told.
Okay, the same chapter. Can you read for me the same chapter? The same chapter. The same chapter. The same chapter saying that Jesus. Listen, 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 listen. Did Jesus in the same chapter, he says, when this and this. Listen, listen, let me answer you. Is it true in the same chapter? Is it true in the same chapter? Let me answer you. You ask me a question. You ask me a question. Let me answer you. Yes, you can, but let me answer you first. Is it true? Shut up. Let me answer you. Is it true in the same chapter? Jesus says, when this happened and this happened and this happened and this happened, the judgment day will happen. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. So how he do not know? How he do not know? Let me explain to you now. What Jesus is saying, that it's based on the man deception and the man evil judgment that will happen. We don't believe in a preset date. You Muslims believe in preset date. And now, as long as you are asking, who is the one who knows judgment day? Is the one is God? That means Allah cannot be God. Jesus is God. He proved it to you from that chapter, the same chapter you mentioned. If we go here in the Quran, read with me carefully. In the Quran, hold on, hold on. In the Quran, in the Quran, you will see Allah saying in chapter 54, you can speak, no problem. Chapter 54, verse number 1, Allah said, the hour is near and the moon is split. But that is a sign of a judgment day started. So Allah gave a false prophecy.
Yeah.
Allah do not know the judgment day. He claimed the judgment day is near, but this is not that happened for 1400 years ago. Go ahead.
Sir, in Surah 67, the people ask like, when will be the day of resurrection be?
When?
But Muhammad says its knowledge is only with Allah.
Okay, is the one talking in chapter 54 is Allah or this is his cousin?
So I'll read it to you.
It's, who is the one talking in chapter 54? My friend, who is the one talking? Okay, I get it. Only but Allah knows the judgment day. Hold on. Yeah. I got
they
that.
Say, when will the promise come to pass if you're telling the truth? So God says to Muhammad to say the knowledge is with Allah only.
Okay.
I'm only a plain warner.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. How Allah knows the judgment day?
Let me finish.
I am letting you finish because you are not answering my question. How Allah he knew the judgment day, yet he say in chapter 54, verse number 1, the hour is near and the moon is split.
Heaven. My father only.
You see,
it is true that
let me ask you. Did you say you are trying to avoid? You are trying to avoid a disaster. You just said my father only. Did you say that? Did you say Jesus, my father, said my father only?
Yeah. Jesus
okay.
Says,
do you believe that Jesus, only, his father, is God? Do you believe? Do you believe? Okay. Okay. When Jesus, do you believe in this verse to be true? Jesus telling the truth.
What, sir?
Do you believe when Jesus he said only my father?
What,
when Jesus says only my father, according to you,
yeah.
Did Jesus told the truth in this verse?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you just admitted. So you admitted that Jesus. Jesus said that he is the Son of God, and you said this is the truth.
Yeah, but
okay, thank you very much, guys. This Muslim, he admitted that Jesus is Son of God. So who is the one who knows the judgment day? Who is the one who knows the judgment day? I'm asking you, hold on. Who is the one who knows the judgment day? The father of Jesus, correct? I don't hear you. Repeat again, I lost you. Who is the one who knows the judgment day? I don't hear you, my friend. Who is the one who knows the judgment day? Is that the father of Jesus? I don't hear you. If you have YouTube running, close it.
Jesus, what he wanted to, can him.
I don't hear you. No, your voice is cutting badly.
Hello.
Okay. Okay. You just said that Jesus. Jesus
now?
Said. Yeah, I hear you. Jesus said that his father is the only one knows the judgment day. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. And you agree that Jesus have a father and his father is God. Do you agree?
I don't hear you.
Say again. Do you agree that Jesus' father is God?
Yeah.
I don't hear you.
Yeah, but Jesus, what he's trying to
say. No problem. Okay. So you are trying to say to me that Jesus is not God, he's a son of God. Is that what you are saying?
No, I'm saying, I'm not saying he's son of God. I'm just saying.
No, you said that because you said Jesus said only my father. No, you just said that.
Automatically, Jesus not God.
So what?
So it automatically makes Jesus not a God because he doesn't know the knowledge of the hour.
Okay, hold on. If Jesus do not know the hour, that will make him not God. That means Allah is not God too. Because Allah in chapter 54, verse number 1, prophesy that he is saying to us that the judgment day started. But as you see, this is 1400 years ago.
Which verse can I...
You see how many times I need to repeat it? Chapter 54, verse number 1.
Okay. Mm. Well, chapter 54, verse number
1.
Well, yeah, it says that the hour has drawn near.
Mm.
The God is threatening. I mean, God is giving us warning that hour is near. So we have to be prepared for the hereafter.
This is the hour. Yeah, the hour is near. How near it is? How near it is? And the moon is split. Did the moon split? Is it splitting the moon? Is a sign of the judgment day. Is it splitting the moon? Is a sign of a judgment day.
Yeah.
Okay. That's mean the judgment day started.
Yeah. No, it doesn't mean judgment has started.
Okay, hold on.
One of the signs of
judgment. No, it means that. Hold on. Hold on. Did your prophet claim that if the Christians, the Christians did not believe, Allah will make their faces, mm-hmm. He will erase their faces?
What, sir? I didn't understand.
Did Muhammad claim mm-hmm. that if the Christian mm-hmm. do not believe in him, Allah will mm-hmm. erase their faces? Yes or no?
No. Muhammad told that if the people of the scripture, either Jews or Christian, doesn't believe in me after knowing me that I'm the messenger, they will be destined in hell.
No.
So they will surely enter hell.
No, read for me. That's chapter 4. Just hold on. Chapter 4, verse number 47. Muhammad claiming that in during his lifetime, if you don't believe, you Christians and Jews, mm-hmm. by me, Allah will erase your faces and he will make them pigs and monkeys.
Can me chapter number and
chapter verse number? 4, verse number 47. Allah will erase our faces, will make our eyebrows go, our eyes go, our nose go inside our head, and our mouth will be in our back, and we will not be able to talk no more. And this is he's saying, as we did to the people of the Sabbath, this is mean that will be done now and during the time of Muhammad's life, not in the judgment day. How Allah he prophesied of such a thing which never happened?
Is it chapter number 4 and 47, right?
Yes.
Yeah, the 47 verse says, "All you have been given the scriptures, believe in what we have revealed, confirming what is was before you, before we efface face and turn them inwards or curse them as curse the Sabbath breakers, and the commandment of Allah is always executed."
Did Allah do that?
Yeah, God is giving them a warning.
What warning? If you don't believe
God
in Muhammad,
is
right?
Them a warning that
okay,
believe in what we have revealed, confirming what is before with you before we face faces.
Is that a false warning or a true warning?
When they broke,
is that a prophecy? Sure. Is that a prophecy?
No, it's not a prophecy. God is giving
prophecy?
Me a warning. So that same thing, what happened
it's
to you?
It's a prophecy, prophesying what he would do to them. No, it's God a prophecy. You see, obviously you do not know what prophecy. Secondly, name for me one Christian. Name for me one Christian. Hold on. Name for me one Christian. Allah, he erased his face because you don't believe in Muhammad.
No, God is telling me.
What?
Give them warning because same thing happened. Because
I know it's a warning, but this should happen. Should happen in the lifetime of Muhammad. Listen, he said the same as we did to those who broke the Sabbath. Those who broke the Sabbath, Allah did not curse them, make them monkeys in the judgment day. He made them right away pigs and monkeys immediately. So the Christian and the Jews, Allah comparing them to those who broke the Sabbath. Okay, did Allah make the Christian and the Jews as he said? The same as he did to the Sabbath people, yes or no?
No, God didn't make it's the God's mercy that he didn't turn them into monkeys.
What do you mean?
It's a blessing from God that he didn't do it.
He did not do it? Allah did not make the Jews pigs and monkeys?
No, he did during the Sabbath when they broke the Sabbath. So God is telling, believe in what he said before I turn into monkeys.
So
God is giving them.
Is he making here a false threat? Are you saying to me, God's are you threat? Saying to me, Allah here was lying, he don't mean it?
No, I'm not telling he's lying or he's giving them a warning.
Okay, but do he mean the warning? Do he mean what he says?
Destroy. God has given them a warning.
Okay, he gave them the warning. Did he do the warning? Yes or no?
No, he didn't. He didn't do it.
Why?
Thank to God's mercy that he didn't do it.
What is the mercy? So he's
it's a decision of God.
Do Allah knew that he will be merciful? He will not do it. So you are saying to me, Allah later he changes mind, or Allah do not know that later he will forgive them?
No. God didn't change his mind. He just gave them warning. Same thing might happen.
Okay. Is the warning a true warning or false warning? Listen. You are just a kid. You are trying to run away from the question. I'm asking you a simple question. Did Allah do it? You said no. Why he did not do it? You said Allah mercy. Okay. Where was Allah mercy with the Jews when they broke the Saturday?
I don't know why God was angry at them.
Okay,
God,
here we go. Each time I ask you, you say I do not know. Each time the question is embarrassing, you say I do not know. So we go to the we don't know again.
No, it's not.
Okay, let me ask you. The Jews, Allah, he made them pigs and monkeys for what reason? What is the reason for Allah to make them pigs and monkeys? We cannot talk in the same time. Listen, don't make me hang up on you. What is the reason for Allah to make the Jews pigs and monkeys?
Because they broke the Sabbath.
Okay, which one is important? To believe in Allah or to fish in Saturday to Allah? The Jews and the Christian refused to believe in Muhammad and Allah. Allah, he made the Jews pigs and monkeys for fishing in Saturday.
Yeah.
Which one is more big a crime to Allah? Fishing in Saturday or not believing in Muhammad and his God?
So
I lost you. I don't hear you. Which one is more important? Somebody did fishing on Saturday, or somebody he don't want to believe in Muhammad and his God? Are you there? I don't hear you. Which one is more important after believing?
That is much more sinful.
My friend, the Jews are believing too, and the Christians supposedly they are believing. Isn't the Quran says a Christian and Jews they will go to heaven?
What, sir?
Isn't the Quran? You see, let me show you how not. I don't want to insult you, but you have a low IQ. You just said the Jews at that time, those who broke the Sabbath, they are believing. But those are the Jews, they're still the same. They are the Jews still, the same Jews. They are Jews, they believe too. So why Allah, he made the Jews monkeys at that time, he will not make them now?
Or he can destroy the whole nation, that like the people of
he can't. Okay, listen.
Yeah, God.
The purpose of your call to prove to me is Jesus is not. Hold on. You are trying to escape whatever we say. Let me ask you. You are trying to prove to me that Allah is God and Jesus is not God, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. How Allah in the Quran he says that a sperm became a dead blood.
What?
How Allah he is God, yet he claimed that the baby happened in a certain way that the nutfah, which is a sperm, became a congealed dead blood. How such a stupid mistake happened? We are talking about God.
No. Tell me the verse. I'll verify you. Tell me the verse.
Any verse you want. Chapter 23, verse number 14.
Okay, one second. Chapter number 23, verse number.
Chapter 23, verse number 14.
Yeah, we have
so Allah, he knew that. Allah, he knew, yeah, guys. Exactly. Allah, he knew the judgment day, but he do not know how the baby is created.
Sir, you should know what a nutfah is. Nutfa is a mixture of male and female sperms.
Let me get you busted. Okay, let me get you busted. You just said that nutfa is a mixture of female and male. Do the women have a nutfa?
They have
what?
female has eggs and male have sperm. So okay. The mixture of these two okay. things is neutral.
All right. Is the eggs of the woman is her orgasm?
Sir.
What? I'm asking you. This is science. We are talking about science. My friend, I'm trying to learn from you. Is the egg of the woman is her orgasm? Yeah, yeah. So when she have orgasm, the water come out. Is that her egg?
No. The sperm goes into the egg. That's what the biology.
Okay,
yeah.
So the egg is inside her body. That's okay. So are you saying? Okay, are you saying the egg? Okay, are you saying? My friend, let me talk. My friend,
that is what
listen. Can you do something so we don't talk in the same time, please? Like, so you, the egg, where is the egg is located? Is it in her private part or inside, deep?
Inside.
Okay.
In her ovaries.
All right. And the egg is coming from where?
It's already there.
Okay. So how do you explain to me in the Quran, chapter 86, verse number 6 and 7, the Quran says that women, they have a sperm, and that sperm is coming from their chest. Location exactly
wait.
The location of the necklace.
Okay 86 chapter 86
6 and 7.
Okay, yeah, it's created from water gushing forth proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs. Yeah,
okay,
God, I think it means sperm.
Okay, the sperm is coming from the ribs of who?
Between the ribs and the backbone of a man, then who else?
A second ago, everybody heard you saying that Allah there is talking about the nutfa. The nutfa is a mixture between a man and a woman.
Exactly.
Okay. So now what you are saying, the man, so are you saying to me that Allah is saying that the sperm of the man is coming from between the backbone and the ribs?
No, I mean it's like the penis is...
My friend, where is the nutfa is coming from?
Ribs and backbone,
the gushing forth of fluid. The gushing forth of fluid. It's a fluid. It is a gushing forth of fluid. It's coming from where?
Yeah.
From where?
It's coming from the penis and there.
So this is not about the women too.
I mean, God might. No, it's not about. It might not be about.
Let us go to the interpretation. Is that okay?
Man.
Can we go to the interpretation, please?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. We will go to the interpretation. Hold on. Let everybody see
God
your.
Doesn't say no,
let everybody
God
see
doesn't
your
say
deception. No, you are a deceiver. You are not honest, my friend. You know that this is not true. Here we go. This is your scholar. You claim to be a Sunni, Muslim Sunni. This is Ibn Kathir. He is a Sunni like you. Here we go. See what the man he is created from. Read carefully with me. I'll put it on the screen. He created from water gushing forth, meaning a sexual fluid that outbursting from the man and the woman. Actually, you agreed with that. You said the nutfa, you are yourself, you said the word nutfa is the man and the woman. Did you say that? Okay. The child will proceed from both of them by permission of Allah. Then, proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs, meaning the backbone of the man and the ribs of the woman.
No. That's not what it means. That's not what it means.
My friend, this is Ibn Kathir.
Yeah, he could be. He could, sir. That just because Ibn Kathir says it is, that it cannot be.
So you are saying Ibn Kathir.
Taken as a true fact.
Okay, let me. So you are saying Ibn Kathir is an idiot.
Because the original Quran, we have to go back into. You have to understand the true meaning. Just because
do you believe your prophet? Okay, do you believe your prophet?
Doesn't mean that it is always
true. Do you believe your prophet is a liar?
Right now?
Do you believe that your prophet is a liar?
No, of course not. How can he be liar?
Okay, so how you explain to me then this? The message of Allah said. The man water is thick and white, and the woman water is thin and yellow. Whichever of them comes first, the child will resemble the parent.
No, where is it? Is it in Hadith?
Yes, it's in a Hadith, and it's Sahih.
Sir, I want to tell you one thing.
You want to tell me something? Don't call me again.
After seven...
I want to tell you something. Let me tell you something. You are a scam, and you are a liar. Let me tell you something. Because it doesn't matter how many proof I give you, you will play games. Your prophet get you busted. In the beginning, you said that nutfa. Oh, you don't understand the word nutfa. It is the male and the female. My friend, it doesn't matter, by the way, it's a male or a female. It is saying that it is will become a congealed blood. So your God, he knew the judgment day, yet he do not know how the baby is created. Have you ever heard of a God like this? Go to elementary school, they will teach you. So you are coming to me with God, who he believe that the nutfa, which by the way is not what you said. Nutfa, when we say the word nutfa, we mean the sperm of the man, the sexual liquid of the man only. Secondly, for the sake of argument, let us say nutfa is male and female sexual fluid, as Muhammadi claimed when he said the women have a sperm and the man have a sperm, which is false because women have no sperm. That nutfa will turn into a piece of a thick dead blood. Who in the world want to believe in such a madness? So wherever you go, it's false. And then that dead blood will became a lump, and then the lump became a flesh, and then after that the lump became bones. And this is absolutely false. Go and read science. The last thing will happen is bones, and then we flesh recover the bones. To get you more busted, your prophet, he insists to get you busted. Muhammad, he claimed that whoever comes first, that will control the gender of the baby. That's absolutely stupid, because women, actually most of Muslim women, they never have orgasm because they have circumcision. They don't even know what orgasm is. So what does it have to do with the baby gender and the look of the baby? He's a liar. But the second you show them something very embarrassing, they try to say, oh, Ibn Kathir, he do not know. Oh, this guy, he do not know. This is what the Quran is saying. And this is what Muhammad, he said. And the same exact story they say to us. Allah, he knew the judgment day. But Allah, he said, the sun set in murky water. You ask them how this happened. They say to you, oh, no. This is how this guy, Zulqarnain, he thought. But the guy is talking there is Allah. He did not say he thought. He reporting a fact of a find. And then Muhammad, he got them busted, trying to defend the Quran. We go to the hadith, we find Muhammad saying the following. Is Muhammad lying? Ibn Kathir don't understand. Do Muhammad understand? Oh, let me tell you, there's many hadith are fabricated. All of your Islam is a fabrication. And where you get the conclusion that Allah, he was not saying the sun set in murky water? This is your conclusion. So look what they do. They come with false explanation for a verse saying it clearly that he found it sitting in murky water, not he thought. He found, this is your Muslim translation. He found it. He reached the sitting place of the sun. That alone is enough to prove this, how stupid the God of Islam is. Where is the sitting place of the sun? Where is that? It's a sitting place of the sun. He found it sitting in a spring of muddy water. They lie and they say this is the ocean. He thought it's the where the sun said. He did not see the first. He did not see the word. The word ocean is not mentioned. It says a spring of muddy water. It's a spring of water. No ocean there. That because there is a legions of some people believe that the sun every day sleep in a spring of muddy water to explain why some water is boiling. It's not really a boiling water, but it says, by the way, it's not the muddy. Translation is wrong. It says it's a muddy, yes, but it is hot, boiling. So in order to explain why this boiling water is happening, it is muddy and it's boiling, but this is because of the earth magma activities. So they could not explain it. They come to a conclusion that obviously the sun goes inside that water. And Muhammad, he took it and he put it there. And then this man, he walked a different direction. And then he reached the place where the sun come from. because those people, they believe that the sun goes from here, they appear in different direction from the other side of the earth. So he found the side where the sun rise, and he found the sun rising on the people. I thought the sun rise everywhere, even in Alaska, even in the South Pole, even in the North Pole, the sun rise. Where is the rising place of the sun? And then the story of lion continue. There was a nation who they are not a human. They are called Gog and Magog. This guy, he want to convince us that Allah, he knew the judgment day. Where is Gog and Magog? Zulqarnain, he built a bridge between us and them. And Gog and Magog are not a human. Muhammad described them that their ear is bigger than a tent and they sleep inside it. And each one of them, he can have six until he have 1,000 baby before he die. Which means the average of them is 999 to one of us. And actually this is mentioned in the hadith too. Where are they? So if we are 7 billion, that means we should have 70 billion Gog and Magog. And now they are behind a dam. You want to tell me that your God, he knew the judgment day? Your God is a fiction. This is a cartoon. This is a cartoon movie. So the Muslim, they say to you, Jesus says only my Father. But Jesus says to you, when this and this and this and this happened, that will happen. Which means that judgment day, it is in the hand of my Father. But everything my Father have, I have. This is what Jesus said. You cannot take the Bible by a verse and say, I'm going to forget about the rest. I do the work of my Father. And he says, he gave me the judgment and the authority to judge. So Jesus, he said clearly that everything he have is from the Father. Why? He has explained to the Jews that, yes, I am a man. But God in this man is the one who is talking to you. That's why he said, whoever saw me, he saw the Father. For me and him is one. When his disciple says, why you don't show us the Father, and that's it? He said to him, I am with you all this time and you did not know me. Whoever saw me, he saw the Father. And regarding knowing, you Muslims are the last one to know. What are you talking about? And your God is a great example. Fiction, stupid stories inserted in the Quran, and you make him God. How this God can be God after all of this? God who he think women have a sperm coming from their ribs. And this is why I'm not married yet. I'm scared to get married, to take my wife to the bedroom, she take off her bra. Instead of seeing two breasts, I will see two testicles, which is called the breast testicles according to Allah. This is your religion? And you have religion and you have God? This is your God? What is this? So Jesus says, only my Father know. And that's it. That will prove Jesus is not God. That's it. But Jesus says there, what, how exactly the judgment day will happen. And not only that, he said that he is the judge in the judgment day. And not only that, he says, every my Father work and I do the same work as my Father. So if you are honest, you will not take a sentence and leave the rest. You take the rest with the sentence. But Muslims, they always try to play games, hoping that you must be an ignorant, you do not know. And if you are an ignorant, we can play with you. How come the Muslims, they did not see what is written in the Quran, but they can see what Jesus said? When Allah, he threat that he will erase the faces of the Christians that they don't believe. Was he promised in the judgment day? No. The promise was now. And he did not do it. Let me prove to you that Muhammad is nothing but a liar. Muhammad, not only that, he said about the Christians, even he said that about the Muslims. As an example, if you raise your head before the Imam, Allah will make your head a head of a donkey. Name for me one Muslim, he raised his head before the Imam. Allah, he made his head ahead of a donkey. Just one. The story in the Quran about Allah making Jews pigs and monkeys. Why he made them pigs and monkeys? Allah, he made the fish come to them only in Saturday. Have you ever heard of a stupid story like this? Allah told them don't do fishing in Saturday. But he made the fish come only in Saturday. And the people are dying from hunger. Okay, let us say for the sake of argument, this story is true. Those Jews, they broke the Sabbath. Why Allah don't make the pigs and the monkeys of the Jews today? Go to Israel, they have festival for gays and lesbian in Saturday. When in Saturday, where is Allah? So Allah, he made the Jews who believe in Allah supposedly pigs and monkeys for fishing in Saturday, but he will not make those who break the command of Allah today. What about making a rapist a pig? Which one is more important? Somebody doing fishing to feed his family, I make him a pig and a monkey, but somebody he raped children's, I don't do that to him. Stupid stories. Madness. How you can believe in this? The Muslims are doing their best to do to give us dislike. Okay, give dislike as much as you like. Still, you cannot answer me. And the proof, here we go. We got your Abdul, who want to prove to us that Allah is God and Jesus is not. He faced a big failure. Three messengers in the Quran are the messengers of Jesus. They did miracles in the name of Jesus. They resurrected people from death. Go and read the interpretation of all scholars. All of them agree that those three messengers, they did miracles in the name of Jesus. No problem. Maybe we can take him next time if there's more Muslims. Today we are going to be off soon. We are here for long. I'm losing my voice. So as you see, guys, a Muslim, they take a verse and they try to play with it. The Bible is a book, and what Jesus said, either you take all of it or don't take any. When Jesus says, "The one who saw me, he saw the Father," then you explain to me, what does that mean? When Jesus said in the same verse you are quoting for me, "My Father," and you just admitted that Jesus is the Son of God, that means Muhammad is a liar. Even if we assume, as what you are saying, that Jesus do not know, by admitting that Jesus saying the truth there, because I asked him, did Jesus say the truth there? By saying, "My Father," he said yes. Okay, that means Muhammad is a liar. Because the Quran says that the Christians are kuffar for believing that Jesus, Son of God. They are desperate. And look, guys, we and the Muslim, we debate about Jesus, if he is God or not. In the same time, we debate about Muhammad, if he is a fraud or not. Do you see the difference? Jesus is so good to the point, we as a human, we are debating, is he God or he's a man? He's so good. In the same time, we are debating about Muhammad, how this man can be a prophet. We are not debating about him to be God or to be an angel. We are debating about how fraud he is. Do you see how huge a difference is? In the top of that, when the Quran claimed that the miracles of Jesus was given by Allah to Jesus, which means the authority, the ability, that make it even more stupid, because I can say I am the one who gave Jesus the ability. What is the proof? Allah, he failed to give any proof of his ability as God. As an example, the Arab, they keep saying, why your God don't give you a sign, a miracle? And Allah says, I'm not going to give them a miracle. Why? Not only that, he said, I refrain from giving miracle. Have you ever heard of such a thing? God, he says, I refrain from sending miracles. Suddenly Allah have a strike. He joined the yellow vest in France. He don't want to go to work. He refused to give signs. And what is the excuse? That people before, they've been given miracles and they refuse to believe. That's a big fat lie. Here we go. We are the people of the book who came before Islam. We believe in the miracle of Jesus and the miracle of the prophets in the Bible before Muhammad and after Muhammad. So this is a false excuse. And if God will not give miracle because somebody don't believe, then what is the purpose of the miracle? Jesus gave miracles and many people don't believe until now. So why Allah gave him miracles? If the reason is, if those people don't believe, we will not give miracles. According to Islam, all the Jews did not believe. Only 12 believe. This is how funny the argument of Muhammadan. Bankruptcy. And you notice how they change the topic in a speed of light. And any second, any time you say something very embarrassing, they say, I do not know about that. To cut it, like, okay, don't talk about it. I don't know about that. Suddenly, he do not know. From a person who want to convince me that Jesus is not God, suddenly he do not know about his religion. He know about my Bible. Deception. Deception is the way. But deception does not work with us. And by the way, just to show you how stupid this verse is, I don't know how many of you notice what is the most stupid about it. Don't the Muslim, they say the Quran is a miracle? Don't they say that? They say that, right? The Quran is a miracle, which is a very funny miracle. So how you say we refrain from giving miracles, but yet you are making Quran? If the Quran itself is a miracle, that's mean you are making a miracle already. It's like saying to me, while you are making hummus, I'm not going to make hummus. You know what I mean? If the Quran is a miracle, how you say we refrain from giving miracles? By saying the sentence, you just did miracle. Because nobody can may say that we refrain from sending. This is a miracle. I mean, have you ever? I refrain from eat falafel. This is the miracle. Where is the miracle in that? Actually, the Arab, the Muslim, they say to you that the Arab, they were amazed with the Quran. Let us show you what the Quran says about what the Arab would say. The Arab, they were laughing at the Quran. And not only that, they said, if we want to bring something like it, we can. But it's stupid. It is stupid. Read carefully. Chapter 8, verse number 31. Was the Arab amazed with the Quran, or they were dying laughing from it? When our sign reached to them, this is the Quran, they say, we have heard this before. If we wish, we could say word like this. They are nothing but the tales of the ancient. They say to you, they lie to you, they say the Arab, they were amazed about how powerful the Quran, they were dying laughing. Not only that, they say it's a fairy tales. This is what the Arab, they say to Muhammad. In his face. Do you see it? So what the Muslim will say to us now? Oh, this is a weak Quran. This is a weak Quran. This Quran is wrong. What about the Quran explaining to us where the hail is coming from? Allah, he claimed that he sent hail from mountains in heaven. Have you ever heard of such a thing? That there is a God who break hail from mountains in heaven. And look at the Muslim translation. They lie, they say, mountain of massy cloud. What? Where is that? Where it says that? Just to show you how they lie in translation, I will go to Muslim website and read the interpretation for the verse. And let us see. Chapter 24, verse number 43. Never ever trust what they translate. You cannot. This website is taking time to open. Let us see in Ibn Kathir then. If this one is not going to open. You cannot trust any Muslim translation because all of it is made to cover up all the mistakes. This is Ibn Kathir. He sent down from the sky, from mountain in it, ice. Do you see it? Do you see it? According to the science of Allah, in the sky, there's mountains of ice. And Allah break ice from the mountains. From min jibalin fiha, from min mountains in it, of min ice, means there are mountains of hail in the sky, which Allah He sent down ice. I mean, isn't it obvious? This is God. This is God. He knew the judgment day. Here we go. He knew how ice is made. There's a mountain of ice. In the heaven, Allah bring the slash hammer, He break the ice, and He throw it at us. Isn't it obvious? Or what about chapter 13, verse number 13, where Allah, He says, the angel is a thunder, and he is in charge of the cloud. And they ask the prophet, and what is that fire we see? He said, this is his fire belt, we beat the cloud with it. Shall we go there? Obviously, Allah is God. He knew the judgment day. Look, He discovered that Mr. Thunder is an angel. Isn't it obvious? Where is the thunder? 12, 13. Here we go. Aradu, the thunder. They took it off. They took it off. Look, look, look. They took it off from Ibn Kathir. Where is the interpretation? Where is the interpretation? It's gone. Where it says that he, you know, the thunder is an angel. It's gone. I don't see it. What? This is not the first time. Always they do that. Look at this website. The website. This is a website owned by the king of Jordan. This why is not working. Look at this. Let us go here, chapter 13, verse number 13. I hope it's going to work. From Ibn Kathir translate. Do you remember, guys? I was talking to Dr. Rohin the other day, and he was reading for me the translation, and I showed him in Arabic all the Arabic text, which is embarrassing. It does not exist in the English translation. Read with me. The thunder, by whose command is an angel. It's also said it's the voice of the sky. So do the angels. And also said, blah, 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 blah. This is Ibn Abbas. Let us see Jalalain. The thunder is an angel who is in charge of the cloud, driving them while constantly proclaiming his praise, that he says, glory be to God. This is what the thunder sound is. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah. This is in his language, the thunder language, huh? And so two angels proclaim. And if you go in more interpretation, you will see that there's thunder. He is in charge. His name, the angel, his name is Thunder. And he have 70,000 angels in the right side of his hand and 70,000 in the left side of his hand. And when he move his stick to the right side, like a maestro, they scream. And the second sound we hear is the other 70,000. Yeah, we prove it always. Anyway, guys, we are here for long. It's getting late for you guys in many places. And for me, I have many things to do. I have books to work in. I hope we have a good time. Please don't forget to download my videos because they will not stay for long. You can cut them pieces. You can share them on your channel. You, like this phone call from this Muslim Abdul trying to lie to us, you can take it. I mean, help us to spread the truth. For this is a mission not of one man. I do my part. Please do yours. So tomorrow I will be back, but maybe I will be in my other channel. For those who might ask where is the other channel will be, we will post a link for you. That channel have nothing to do with religion. We talk about different issues, which is important for us. It can be not important for you, depend what we are talking about. So I want to say thank you for being here. I say thank you for those who support us. Really, always we appreciate you. And I appreciate people keeping their language clean during the time we are live, because by doing that, you support our channel and we maintain a good level of profession and being Christians. For us as a Christians, we don't hate the Muslims. And even if somebody lied to us, I don't, you know, I'm not angry from him. I'm angry from the lie. I hate lies. And the Bible says that the devil is the father of all lies. And always you lie when you know there is something wrong. And this is what the Muslims, they do when they debate us about their religion. They lie in order to cover what is wrong. They knew it's wrong. Otherwise, they will not lie. A person who is proud about his belief, he will never lie about it. Trust me. He will say this is what it is. You like it, like it. But because they knew in their heart that this is a very bad religion, and the only way to defend it is to lie. Otherwise, if you are proud, here we go. We show you the proofs. We show you the reference. We don't give our own interpretation. You see, the Muslim, they give us interpretation of the Bible as they like. We don't do that. We show them what they do give interpretation for their book, not what a Christian prince he think. If you ask me about what I think, I will tell you. Allah is the moon god. Allah is sin. You know what sin? How many of you knows what sin? You can go right now and search. Even in the Quran, chapter 36, it says, Yasin. Yasin. Who is sin? Sin is the moon god. The same as Baal. Have many names. And look how the Muslims explain the verse. Allah knows best what he meant by those letters. Ya is a word meaning God. But because Muhammad is a thief, he stole it from the Aramaic language, but yet you do not know what Ya mean. That's why you say Yahweh. Ya is a word meaning God. Doesn't matter what God. Sin is the name of the God. That is the moon God. You can go right now to Google and type sin. Sin. It is the moon God. We know who is Allah. La is the moon god. It just depends in the country. Every country have different name for the same god. La, sin, Baal, they are the same. And Muhammad himself, because he's ignorant. He thought when he spoke in the Quran that Baal is not the same God, but the fact he is the same God. And even Muhammad, he agree that Baal is a creator, but Allah is better a creator. Do you see it? Do you call upon Baal and forsake the best of the creators? You just admitted that Allah is one of many creators, and one of them is Baal. Allah saying that Baal is a creator, but he is better a creator than Baal. So I want to say thank you guys for being here. I hope we are learning. I'm doing my best to make things simple for you. You know, maybe too much knowledge will give you a headache, but I mean, this is how learning process works. We try to make it funny so things will stay in your brain, because sometimes comedy is the best way to make, let us say, information stick in your head. Actually, me myself, sometimes I drive in my car and I'm alone in the car. I laugh, and like I'm traffic light, and people laugh at me. Like I look at me like, what this guy? Why is laughing? Because I remember what a Muslim said to me once, like when he called me. So comedy make a good memory, because that comedy like will brought some pleasure to you, so it's going to stick there for a good time. So Islam is a comedy, and we present it as it is. It is a stupidity, it's comedy, it's fiction, it's a lie, it's a madness, it's all kind of things, including bad things. So I hope people are learning and people are taking notes. All right. So I will announce here when I'm going to go in my other channel live. So if you like to join us, feel free, and you can subscribe to the other channel. But remember, the other channel is not about Islam, have nothing to do with Islam. We speak about everything, about us as a human, what is good for us, you know, opinion of many things. And people are free to ask me questions. I will do my best to help and to give you my opinion. So I want to say thank you. May the Lord bless you. And until we see you soon again, we say and we repeat and we insist to believe in one God. One God. We are not people who believe in gods. We are the one who believe in God, not the Muslims. We are the one who believe in the true God, because he is holy. God is holy, and the God of Islam cannot be God. One of the reasons is not being holy. A God who promised me a bunch of women in the bed in what is called heaven, he cannot be holy God. You can call him a holy pimp. You can call him a holy man from Las Vegas. It's not God. God did not create women to be sex toys. God, he created women from a man, which means women and men. Actually, the Bible called man and women, called them Adam. Adam was a name given for both. Women is not meant to be just another joy for the man. It to complete the man life, and the woman, her life is completed by the man too. So they complete each other. Actually, when God, he took us out of heaven, he gave us another way to live, which means you die but your children live. It's kind of a way to live, to continue living after death. This is how God is a beautiful is. You die, but yet you are not dead. He gave you opportunity to reproduce, so your life continue. And your kids present you. And you will be remembered, either for bad or for good. So in the Bible, we learn about different kind of God, which is not exist in the Quran. And never believe the Muslim when they say to you that the God of the Quran is the same God of the Bible. Absolutely false. If we have the same God, at least we will have the same heaven. Jesus said, he and she, they will not be the same. They will not have sex in heaven. They will not get married. They will be the same as angels. We cannot have the same God. Ethic is bad. Promise is bad. Teaching is bad. Even in earth is bad. Hatred, while Jesus was teaching love and mercy. Pray for your enemy. Muhammad says, kill them, cut their fingertips. Allah will heal your chest by torturing them. That is not from God. Thank you very much for being here. And please don't forget to download the videos. They will be taken down very soon. Christ is Lord and Islam is false. And we'll see you soon again. Bye-bye.